The spaceship exploded.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I want to say thanks for having me, Joe.
Michael Douglas on Joe.
Why haven't they ever gotten those 2 months together?
Nobody ever gets pussy anymore.
It's over for us pussy getting guys.
You remember how it used to be? You used to be able to get pussy.
Everybody was getting pussy. That's
everybody true. Used to be able to make fuck.
To make fuck.
Not anymore.
Not anymore.
What do you think? What do you think stopped that? Was it like Obama?
Absolutely. I think it was Obama. I think everybody got scared when I got cancer from eating pussy.
You think Michael Douglas single-handedly made pussy eating dip? Oh yeah, he's scared. I couldn't eat pussy for years after that.
Yeah, man, I'll take a fucking puff.
Take a pull off Cushy Dreams.
I'll take a pull off of Cushy Dreams weird pipe.
What are we smoking here? What's this?
This is peace.
Peace, bro.
That's what this show needs.
We're smoking the peace pipe.
Yeah. It's, you know, maybe they should do it P-I-E-C-E.
Yeah, like a gun?
A piece of pussy.
Yeah.
Getting peace.
That's awesome.
How does it taste?
Tastes delicious, dude.
I don't know. I'm driving after this.
Why don't you drive your dick into my ass?
Honestly, that shit is really nice, dude.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
I'm literally going to smoke a joint when I get home. Look, honestly, I'm not even kidding. My wind down is just a little mini can of Diet Dr. Pepper and a fucking joint of Cushy Dreams.
Yeah. Wow, that was a nice healthy rip off that.
The peace pipe. Mm.
So get your chillums, get your bongs.
Yo, dude, I used to love I wanted a chillum, so like a glass fancy chillum so bad.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's the one that's just a little straight tube.
It's straight, yeah.
Yeah, but it was such a
good
name.
That's what like the jam band kids were always into.
Because that was professional.
The fish kids.
That's to weed. That's to
serious
weed instruments
smokers.
As the Saturday Night Special is to a gun. You know what I mean?
A little 38.
Yeah, just you have it on your fucking ankle. I wish I had a strength.
You're not for show. You're for go.
I'm for go.
I wish I had a little 38, like an old
get
cop
a snub
gun,
nose, dude.
No, like the kind of, like old cops used to wear when they dress like mailmen.
Yeah, snout nose.
Yeah.
I would
listen.
Love
what the hell are you doing in there? You doing crime?
I would love a lady's
come out with your
gun.
Penis out.
Come out and let me see your penis.
Come out and let me suck your penis. At CushyDreams.com, promo code Cumtown for 20% off your penis.
Dude, when are they going to get... You know, it's over, right? By the time they get big penis technology,
mm-hmm.
I'll be retired from the getting pussy game.
We'll be dead.
Mm-hmm.
But when are they going to make that happen?
It's about damn time.
You know what? Honestly, I did see some article about it's not new information, but like nanotechnology to like eat tumors or whatever.
Yeah.
And
can they make that grow? Can they
honestly
throw up
that
dick?
It made meat? Me feel it made no. I don't care about that shit. I can't that tempers and seasons me to have a broken garbage dick and to be like kind of I want to keep all my flaws. I just don't want cancer.
Yeah. Stav, would you, if science was able not to grow your penis bigger, but to grow a second beautiful penis,
or even better, to make everyone else's dick smaller, you take pills that to you just taste like Sour Patch Kids.
Oh, it's candy too.
Yeah,
I mean, yeah, I would do that.
Mm. Wait, but what if you grew a second penis that really
just Professor X in that room making everyone's dick smaller? This mind, but just all the fucking monitors of just guys in bathrooms just freaking out.
Yeah.
So wait, Adam.
Or alternatively, Neo from The Matrix.
Yeah,
that.
Either one.
That would be good. Yeah, with the thing plugged.
Where's
into
the actually? Where's the new dick growing?
It's right next to your regular dick.
To the right, to the left, on
and
top.
It really puts your regular dick to shame. Yeah. But you're
can't
gonna
I
have
just
two
get
penises.
It chopped off.
No. Just give me Morpheus, and we'll give you whatever you want. I want to have a big dick. When I come back, I could be homeless, but I want my dick to be fucking big.
Do you remember there was that Reddit Emma with a guy with two penises?
Reddit Emma. Come on, Adam. Stop.
What?
I want to cut your hands
Stop,
off.
Dude.
Why?
You knew what you were doing when you said it that way. Why
no,
do you
people
do
say
Why
Emma.
Why do you do shit like
they
that?
They do say
Emma. Why? Honestly, that pisses me off so much.
You know what that means? Form a cup of the mineral spirits.
Stop. We just smoked peace.
I know, and you ruined it. Don't put it on me.
No,
you said Emma,
it.
Motherfucker. It's AMA. Everyone knows that.
People say AMA.
No one says that.
Honestly, it is crazy how the smokable CBD actually does work.
It does. Yeah.
I feel chill.
I feel great. I feel, like I'm...
When I take a hold whole little joint to the face, I basically feel high.
I mean, yeah, you don't feel high. Like, it's none of, it's being high without any of the, like, great, well, now my brain just doesn't work for an hour.
Yes, yes.
Which is the bad part of being high.
Figure out, like, how to turn the light on in the bathroom. I'm like, did I have, oh, right, it's a motion sensor.
But yes, Adam, to answer your very annoyingly asked question, the content was worth discussion. Yes. And I do remember that AMA with that guy that had two cocks.
And they were pretty big penises.
They were pretty big.
But they found out that was a fraud. And
was,
you know,
it
how
a fraud?
They caught
what?
Him? They caught him because he was photoshopping.
I believed.
He was photoshopping
it. Yeah, dude, I'm older.
But then he got caught because he kept making his two dicks bigger. It was an Icarus.
He flew too
it was
close.
A two dickerous situation. Yeah.
Two dickerous.
I didn't know that. That sucks, dude.
I feel
you just
I
ruined
feel,
my I'm not my childhood.
I feel lied to.
Because it was college, but you ruined
Yeah,
that.
You remember when you found out Santa Claus's dick wasn't actually big?
Yeah, that was
that,
crushing.
Dude. My dad was using a dildo that whole time.
Yeah.
It was sort of a Santa doesn't cry situation.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Oh, wow, damn. I can't believe that guy was a fraud. Yeah. I remember also he said that because he had two penises, he used it to fuck men and women.
Yeah, that I remember the guy was bi.
That
he
kind of
bi.
Shit should have, like,
tipped you off.
Yeah.
I guess.
Yeah,
but if
true.
Ian had two dicks, he would do that.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, well, Ian has one dick and he does that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, so it doesn't change.
No, but that's what I mean. If he had two dicks, that's how he'd use them.
If he didn't have no dicks, he would do that.
That's my fucking point. No matter how many dicks.
We are high right now.
No, I'm making sense.
We're high.
I'm making fucking sense.
We're high off cushy.
Yeah, let me hit you with this about Wheat Thins.
All right. I'm listening.
How do you feel about them?
I've always liked them.
I love them. I love the way they kind of turn into like a clay texture. Mm-hmm. You know?
The texture in your mouth when they're like
I also
wet.
Like
makes
Triscuits.
Me feel like a sculptor, you know, like Michelangelo.
Yeah, Michelangelo. Yeah, yeah.
Like I'd spit that shit out and it'd be like, let me show you a beautiful man with a baby's penis.
I got to say, I prefer Triscuits.
Triscuits are better.
Okay, that's fair.
But there's a wide world of crackers out
I'm
there.
I'm with you. I just had to
say
if
I was
there.
Like, how do you feel about Fig Newtons? I'd be like, they're pretty good.
They're
you
awesome.
Wouldn't be like, Oreos are better. It's like, well, no shit.
You know, but you know what, though? They occupy a different place in my head.
The Nabisco
whereas,
product.
Whereas at a certain line. Point, I wouldn't even necessarily. And this is a crazy take. I understand
the
a lot of people.
The fuck is up with the Nabisco logo? By the way, you tell you, one of the
diamond,
laziest
right?
logos of all time.
I've never.
They're like,
a
yeah, it's like a fucking corner, and there's a circle, and then there's
that.
Like an antenna on it.
Let me check it out.
I mean, it's like it's dog shit.
We should go into branding.
After
I mean,
it looks like
over.
The it looks like somebody's like community college graphic design homework.
Yeah, it's bad.
Yeah, what's up with the antenna?
Let me see it. Let me see it again.
Why did they draw that?
Fucking assholes.
Sucks.
Certainly no cushy dreams.
Yeah, but I will say this. Wait, the dark truth behind the design of Oreo cookies. What the fuck?
It's Chris D'Elia's family crest.
The D'Elia.
Nabisco stands for Nab the Kids. Let's go.
It's the cross of Lorraine.
Oh.
From the Crusades.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
The Nabisco logo?
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
What? That's Christian?
Yeah, dude.
I can't believe I'm.
Well, now I'm glad the Nazis took that.
Mm-hmm. I can't believe I've been giving my children that Christian propaganda.
Yeah, this is according to SpoonUniversity.com, a very real ass sounding.
Didn't you go there, Stav?
No.
I think you did, dude.
Yeah, I think
no,
you
I
did,
didn't.
Dude.
I think that's how you got promoted to Captain Crunch.
Your old alma mater, huh?
No, I did.
Dude, Spoon
I graduated U? Where's Magnums Comes Loudly at Spoon University.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Jesus Christ. Oh, God. Spoon U really
Spoon
knew how to
party. Spoon U, bro. All the butterscotch pudding you could ever ask for.
This guy was getting so much pussy at Spoon U.
Yeah, I got pussy one time exactly.
Damn.
Off Spoon U.
I'm
going
to go to like
a
big national forest.
That sounds cool.
And eat you know, like one of the with the big pine trees.
Yeah. The sequoias.
Yeah.
Go to California.
I've never been over to those.
And then have like climb to the top of a mountain and I open up and I get up there and I catch my breath. And I look out, and then from my fanny pack, I pull out Fig Newtons and a Capri Sun.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Nice
yes.
little snack.
And then with it,
that's awesome.
Yeah, and I got a pack of natural American spirits in there. And Just fucking getting smoking cigarettes and eating Fig Newtons.
Okay, so the point I was trying to make is Fig Newtons, I would say, sometimes in my life, are better than Oreos. Mm-hmm.
When I was a kid, I thought they were for retarded kids.
No, I thought they were for grown-ups.
No, I literally...
I love Fig Newtons.
I love Fig Newtons, too, but I would eat them, and I'm like, isn't this for, like, retarded
kids? No, I thought they were a mature style of
No, I thought... Honestly, here's how stupid I was. I thought they were, like, toned-down cookies so retarded kids didn't
wouldn't,
get...
Wouldn't go too crazy. Too wild.
Start flinging their poo.
Right, yeah, no, I thought they were, like, safety cookies.
So they wouldn't like
this is as good a cookie as a retard can handle.
They wouldn't stay.
I swear to God,
dude, I believe you,
those
man.
In like Nilla wafers, I thought they were like fucking like, you know, let's put a governor on them to make sure they don't.
Yeah,
you got that.
Wowie kazowie. Can you imagine one of these guys getting their hands on a fucking like, you know, like double chocolate or like Chips Ahoy or something?
They'd have an old fashioned prison riot in special ed.
Mm-hmm. There'd be fucking safety scissors everywhere.
They'd stage a breakout.
Riot,
chaos.
Riot in cell block purple.
they'd have to shoot him, the guards. Mm. They'd have no choice.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, just trank gun them.
Oh, fuck. Oh, baby, that's awesome, dude.
Ooh, baby, I got fucked in my ass because I'm gay.
Because I'm gay.
I just want to... Oh, damn, now I want like a big pepperoni pizza.
That sounds so awesome.
I haven't had pepperoni pizza in forever, dude. Sometimes
I had it.
Whenever I get a pizza, I just go cheese or I do something fancy.
Yeah.
I go order from Nice.
Yeah.
And I'll get
nice
like Le Chev.
Yeah.
Or
like goat cheese.
Yeah, speck.
The Montagnard.
Yeah, speck.
Yeah, and those are always nice, but sometimes just a plain
you need
old
a fucking
fashioned
pepperoni with crispy ass pepperoni.
I'll have the Merovingian.
Yeah, just lost a baseball game style pizza.
Oh yeah, damn Pizza Hut after a fucking
Pizza Hut
after a hard day of fucking playing soccer at Rosedale. Yeah.
Pizza Hut stuffed crust cheese pepperoni. That's what I'm wanting.
You know, I was so pissed when I got stuffed crust.
Couple of fucking spirits.
I don't fuck with stuffed crust.
It's you don't fuck with it?
No, it's not Why good. Not? It's not good. You're right.
It breaks your heart.
It's different. It's not. Cheese. It's honestly not.
Because in theory, it's the best thing.
Sure.
The commercial,
but
the stretch,
I like
the stretch of
never
the cheese
stretches.
In the commercial is so beautiful.
I like the weight it adds to the handle of the pizza.
I'm with you on that. I'm with you on that.
You know
that.
What I'm saying? It's a better grip. It's
and
like,
I still
it's like
will
having,
eat
it's
it,
like having like a Desert Eagle grip on a like a 9mm.
Yeah, I'm with you there, brother.
Yeah, it's like what I want is pizza with a crust, a custom engraved handle.
Yes,
gold plated crust.
Yeah, sure. Oh fuck.
So it's the
what the fuck was that shit where they're cutting the crust off bread for children?
Yeah,
I don't know
what kind of dipped head like
indulgent parents.
Yeah, exactly.
I was not raised.
That's
that
not.
Way.
I understand not eating the crust of pizza. You're wrong to not.
Yeah,
do
I
that.
Don't understand that at all. I understand crust off bread way more than I understand crust off.
Well,
pizza.
Here's the thing: the crust on the pizza is so far removed from the rest of what the pizza is. That it's a breadstick. Mm-hmm. So I can understand liking pizza but not wanting the breadstick aspect because you're just a child and you don't know any better.
I suppose.
Your palate isn't like expanded.
I suppose.
But the crust is it's the end of the sandwich.
Yeah.
Presumably there's fucking still peanut.
I would say the same applies to what you just said about pizza
no.
to
no,
crust.
No, 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 no. Because there's still
it's not as different.
There's toppings in the middle.
But it's a marked difference from the rest of the
no,
bread.
No, it's just there's a brown part. And
it's harder and it's not as fluffy.
It's not as hard. Yes. I mean, it's not harder. Look
it
at,
is harder.
Go get a fucking piece of Wonder Bread. Go get a piece of potato bread. And so this is what I'm talking about.
Here's what I'll say.
You know
say
what I'm
you.
Talking about, right? You've seen this.
I know what you're talking
sandwich.
About. And the parents that would do it for their kids were bad parents.
They're
I
bad
don't
parents.
Agree with either of you.
They were bad parents.
Here's what I did.
Even if you're cutting
overindulgent parents.
Even if you're cutting the sandwich for the child,
this is
my child will have the sandwich that they're getting.
No, cutting it is absolutely
cutting
it's
wrong.
Great.
My child is getting.
I got a diagonal.
Diagonals are great.
No, you're getting a full jar of peanut butter and jelly, and then the loaf of bread in your lunch bag. And you said you got to make this last
Here's
a month.
Month yeah,
month,
he's a month of lunch.
You Can I say something out. Crazy to you guys? You'll probably get mad at this.
You love having sex with women.
No, you're not allowed to say it.
You can. Go ahead.
Peanut butter and jelly sandwich?
Shut the fuck up right now. You're right, Nick. I'm sorry. He's going to say they're bad.
They might be my favorite sweet.
Oh, okay. That is stupid.
That is stupid.
That is stupid, but it's not as bad as saying they're bad. Your favorite sweet?
When was the last time
you had ice cream? A fucking piece of cake?
I might prefer the peanut butter and jelly
sandwich. No, you don't,
bro. When was the last time you had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich?
You're such a fucking bullshit liar.
Than a week ago.
I'm going to break your
ankle. What kind of fucking...
Late at night.
What kind of jam? What kind of peanut butter?
I had, you know, the nice jam with the red and white cap? The
strawberry,
yeah, the picnic shit,
the raspberry, picnic.
Yeah, yeah, that's raspberry? The good jelly.
Raspberry, yeah,
me and my
that's
me
what rich people.
Me and my Estonian Swede wife are going out on a picnic.
Yeah, the picnic
was it raspberry?
No,
what was it?
It was a four berry. Mm, it was a mixture.
And what kind of nut butter?
I had that with Costco peanut butter,
sweetened or unsweetened.
Unsweetened.
Ugh.
But listen.
You're going to say a fucking sandwich with unsweetened peanut butter is your favorite sweet, you fucking prick?
Get his ass.
That's not even a fucking sweet, dickhead.
But listen.
Oh, my God. Two of the three elements are not sweet.
Hear me?
Got his ass. God damn it. If you had sugar in there, if you had some Jif, I'd at least listen. You'd be wrong, but I'd listen to you.
Hear me out.
That chalky fucking Costco peanut butter is a main ingredient in your favorite sweet?
Hear me out.
Get the fuck out of here.
Hear me out.
I don't think I can.
Let's go ahead. Let's fix this by taking that as a jumping off point.
No.
Peanut butter and sandwich. Peanut butter and jelly sandwich. You're absolutely right. We're not letting you finish. Peanut butter and jelly sandwich. And then you threw bacon and bananas in there also.
That's what
awesome.
I was going to say. I put sliced bananas.
Let the record show
and
he was
honey.
Not going to
no
say.
No, I put honey and sliced bananas.
Honey, now we're talking.
And it was like 12:45 in the evening. I was hungry. I was trying to fall asleep, but I was too hungry to fall asleep. You know the vibe?
Listen, a night PBJ is one
and
of the
I
best
And I
the
toasted
world.
The bread. So the
now you're losing
everything
me
got runny.
You're losing
no,
me.
No. Bread. It had a nice.
It's a fucking cold sandwich. You don't toast a fucking PBJ.
No, it had a crunch. The crunch factor was fantastic.
Out of here. Get the fuck
and
out
I poured
of here.
A glass.
The only way
I poured
that
a glass
you can say
of
it's
almond
a sweet.
Milk.
Almond milk.
It was delicious.
There's no fucking creaminess to almond milk.
And
you
I
idiot.
And
you
I
need
dunk.
A fucking cold. You're gonna dunk a hot sandwich in almond milk?
Yeah,
you fucking.
You want it,
you should
if you
die.
Want it crunchy, you gotta just put the bacon strips in the convection oven to get all your crunch from the bacon.
If you're going to make it a sweet, it's got to have cake-like consistency. The bread's got to be white. It's got to be soft.
Okay.
Okay? It can't be crunchy fucking multigrain bread like I know you had.
No.
Like I know you fucking had.
No, I didn't use
it's just, you're just eating a bird's house.
God damn,
no,
you
I
fucking
didn't.
Piss
I
me
didn't
off
have
sometimes.
Like, I didn't have 15 grain, like, yeah. Like,
you definitely did.
Bird seed.
You had fucking...
No. You ate, you ate a merkin with fucking expired jelly in it.
No. I used sourdough bread.
All right, that's fine.
And I toasted it.
Toasting, it's a very, very lightly, maybe.
A light
maybe. But if you're telling me you toasted to the point where the shit is running, you've lost me, and you've lost the elements that make
I
it
will say,
potentially a sweet. To make it a sweet, it's got to be close to a
I'm
fucking
not big
cake.
On sweets. You know this about me.
So then don't fucking come into the dojo then, motherfucker.
I know.
Stay out there. Stay out there with your fucking multigrains and your fucking seeds
I wasn't
and
doing
your
seeds.
Fucking vinaigrettes and shit. Okay?
I didn't put a vinaigrette in there.
Fucking idiot.
But I do like
your favorite
savory.
Sweet is a fucking... Is a Costco brand.
You know, my favorite type of
butter.
Pussy is actually a
man's ass.
All right.
Oh, fuck. You were a fucking asshole, Adam.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
I mean, peanut butter and jelly sandwiches are good.
They're awesome.
But you
They're
know what
so
I... You know, the best would be like something like potato bread... But it's half cheesecake. I don't know how you would get there, but if you could make
I'm
those two,
that.
You get like a bread that's got like sort of like it's somewhere in between potato bread and New York cheesecake where you can hold it and it's not gonna fuck up your like get shit all over your hands. But it's rich and it's cold.
Yeah.
And then peanut butter
cold
jelly.
Cold is so big.
I have a sandwich.
You warming it up.
I have a sandwich idea that I will not
banana,
say on the show.
Bacon.
Because I think that there's a 75% chance it will make me a multimillionaire.
All right. Let's end this episode because I need to hear about the sandwich.
Okay.
I need to know exactly what the sandwich is.
If you want to hear about the sandwich, go to cum.town.
No,
and buy
don't you dare tell anyone.
And buy a shirt. And in the shirt will be the recipe.
It's a modified sandwich. Okay.
Cum.town. Oh, also,
stop getting
already walking back the sandwich concept.
Hear me out. The shirts will be, some shirts will be phased out beginning next month.
last chance to get those
probably
fuckers.
The Andre's Steakhouse shirt
no,
will be phased out.
No, that's very rare. No. That's very rare.
Nope. It's been that's a joke from 4 years ago.
No, I'm saying get them while there's still last. Yeah. Supplies last.
That one's gone. Maybe the Thousand Island Stair that will be gone. Wow. And probably a couple others will be cut out of the rotation.
End of an era.
So if you want them, check them out now, because once that stock's gone, that's it.
That's right.
Bye,
and I think I probably will have some merch up on stobby.biz soon.
Patreon.
Go to patreon.com/cometown.
Yeah,
for double the episodes and all the good shit.
$5
also
a
to
month.
hear the recipe.
The sandwich.
Man. Don't
$1 million sandwich.
The
idea.
$1 million sandwich will be on the Patreon.
I will be editing into.
Do not put that.
And you know what? You can expect an in-depth discussion about how hot Lola Bunny used to be on this week's Patreon.
Yeah, we wish it.
So go to patreon.com /
I fucked her, actually. Come down. I had sex.
Oh, Michael. Welcome to fucking Cumtown. A beautiful day today.
Beautiful Monday.
Beautiful
here
day
Brooklyn.
Here.
It's Tuesday, you fucking
Tuesday.
Dunce.
It's after a long weekend. You know, I take all my bank holidays off just like I take the other 6 days of the week off when we're not recording.
That's right.
Brooklyn, Mexico.
We're in Brooklyn, Mexico.
We're here in Brooklyn, Mexico. It's a beautiful day.
To penis.
My penis.
Touch penis.
Touch penis. Oh, fuck. Damn, so nice out.
It is really nice out.
Suck my dick away. Suck my dick, I'm gay. Bum, bum, bum. I want to fucking stroll out with my titties out.
Yeah.
I can't wait till the summertime, dude.
Yeah, you know what you should get into?
What's that?
Deep V's.
No.
You know also what you should get into?
I don't think so.
Rosary beads and deep V's.
No, I'm not a fucking Catholic, motherfucker.
You don't have to be Catholic. I'm just
Greek
saying
Orthodox.
Just have a more Despacito style, like,
that's
style.
That's not
for
my
the spring.
Fucking style, bro.
Listen, I'm
gold chains.
That.
I'm other bracelets, but rosary beads?
You're Orthodox.
You
what
think
does
I'm
that
a
mean?
Fucking papist?
What, do you have to walk around with an incense like
no,
ball?
Now, first of all, they stole that from us too, but.
No, I thought that's Eastern
what
Orthodox.
What is love?
I love that
oh,
song.
Oh, hell yeah. Mm-hmm. Dude, I loved Night at the Roxbury as a kid. What is
love? It was my favorite movie.
You're copying.
No,
my
I swear to God,
memories.
I rented it for my birthday party.
You're
one
copying
year.
My memories.
You're copying his memories.
I'm not copying, dude.
I love that.
He's copying my memories.
I was them for Halloween.
It's the perfect joke.
He's copying me.
It's a perfect joke for little boys.
You don't understand. There's a guy who's copying me.
That's true, because those characters are little boys.
They're little boys.
They don't understand how pussy works. I had no
idea.
They
hump women. They put a woman. They sandwich a woman. And they just hump her back and forth.
I
thought that was so funny.
I thought that was a great. Me and my boys used to do that at the. Speaking of Greek Orthodox, mm-hmm. at the Goya Greek Orthodox Youth of America.
Yeah,
dances.
I remember I did that too. Actually,
you're a liar.
No,
dude.
Now I was lying. That was a lie.
Okay, because you didn't have.
But the rest of it was the truth.
You didn't have the guts to do it.
No, I couldn't. I couldn't.
You didn't
go,
have the guts to rub your little penis on a girl.
I couldn't.
Under Greek, the guise of a joke.
I'm Greek Orthodox.
Shut the fuck up. Some things are too far.
He's Greek Orthodox.
I'm Greek Orthodox.
That doesn't even make sense. And we don't have any of that in our mm-hmm. gene pool, thank you very much. Greeks are superior. We bred out. The Spartans used to fucking punt retarded
infanticide,
babies.
Infanticide, yeah.
Actually, that's fucked up. I'm Athenian. I'm not a Spartan, dude.
You're an artist.
I'm the fucking philosopher. I'm the brain and the little ass dick. Mm-hmm. Spartans are fucking animals. Everyone who's worshiping 300, no. They were cruel to fucking people with birth defects.
and they all raped each
other. Stop touching my penis.
Whereas Athenians, you couldn't exactly call it rape. It was more sexual coercion of children than raping them.
It was like a training program.
You teach them fucking geometry and philosophy and shit.
Well, it was a mentorship. It was like
mentor.
It was like big brother's little brother.
Suck on my father's dick.
Suck on my father's penis.
Ba-bum. Sucked on my daddy's balls.
It's pretty funny that they figured out a way
suck his dick.
To be homophobic, even though as my dad,
I remember, but man, I miss being a little youngin.
A little youngin, huh?
Man, I remember my daddy. He called me sucking on his nuts while he was asleep. Made me suck. He said, "You gonna sit here? You gonna suck my whole dick? You gonna suck my whole dick?"
And I never sucked another.
And it made me sick. But yeah, man, I had to go to school. We had in chorus class. Everybody's laughing at me because my vocal cords was bruised.
That's why you talk that way.
I thought it was from cigarettes.
Oh no, I'm first generation Taiwanese. my vocal cords. Hey, good afternoon. My name is presidential candidate Andrew Yang.
I think you mean mayoral candidate.
Mayoral candidate Andrew Yang.
Andrew Yang.
That's the thing I love about New York. You go into the bodega.
Stop with that, man.
That is
how you said, "Let me get a chirp cheese and get extra sun on it."
We can either.
Let me get extra sun on the chopped cheese and down
the chopped cheese.
Yeah. Like, hey, man, are you okay? Nah, I'm having a stroke.
We can either have, what was it? We could have cashews or issues?
There's two things you need to know about me.
What a bust nuts.
I'm from Taiwan, and I'm having a stroke.
We have cashews or issues.
You know, we have cashews or Hershey's.
Come down here and bust nuts.
You want to come bust nuts with me? Then we ain't got no problem. But we're going to have a problem, then it's going to be we're going to have problems. We're going to have work. I don't got word problems. I got action problems.
So true.
You know what I'm saying?
Mr. Yang, the question was about school vouchers.
The vouchers will be redeemed for Bitcoin. I already said that. I already said, we don't need no damn schools if you just give the kids cryptocurrency.
If you got,
mm-hmm. Currency.
They got cryptocurrency, but they ain't got no blood row currency. That's the problem, is that there ain't no violence to it.
There needs to be more violence in the crypto markets.
Look, a lot of people, they don't trust me because they know I said the N-word throughout my teen years. Mm. But you have to understand, that was an act of endearment.
That makes him the most New York candidate possible. If as a Chinese teenager he said the N-word, that's... Queens is crawling with those guys.
Have you taken the subway?
Have you taken
Flushing?
The seven?
Yeah.
All it is Chinese kids.
You
want to
call
Caesar's
it the seven?
Close your
saying
eyes.
Saying the N-word.
Like, you know they call it the seven because I grew up on the seven. You know what I'm saying? I'm Chinese. I'm from Flourishing. And I grew up on the seven. They call it the seven because there's seven letters you say when you on that train.
Yeah, no. I don't think that's why they call it that.
Yes, it is.
Yeah. You think it's the seven train is named after the letters in the N-word?
No, it's
the number of letters?
N-I-G-A-F-A-G.
Mm. I don't think that's
the seven
true.
That's on my license plate.
Mr. Yang.
Wait, I'm sorry, Mr. Yang. That's saying that your license plate?
I got a.
Slurs?
You got a vanity plate.
I got a Toyota. I got a stretch limousine Toyota Avalon with NIGAFAG on the license plate.
Wow, that's bad for the city.
That's fucked up.
And I got a parallel perk that?
And we got, look, you know how they got moon roofs? This thing, the entire top glass.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
And then there's a shark tank above
nice.
It.
So oh,
then,
nice.
When you look it up, you just see and shorks.
That's awesome.
You just seeing, and you would drive around the avenues, rubbing down the city in the avenues, and you looking up at sharks eating all the buildings.
Mm-hmm. So I'm sorry. Is that?
And that's called the dollar bill money mentality.
Is it a little?
That's called the cash dollar bill.
So is it a very high Avalon, or are you smushed under the?
Yeah, it'd be on 82s.
Okay,
you got 82
on 82s. No, okay, I understand. So it's high. Mm-hmm. But does that give you enough space to sit if you're under the aquarium?
Hold on. Let me explain something to you.
Yeah.
Because I don't think you understand what we're seeing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't.
I think you're having a bit of a comprehension problem.
I am. I'm having a hard time comprehending the layout of this limousine.
It's on 82s.
But that only makes it higher.
It's on 82s.
It doesn't make the actual inside taller.
It's on 82s.
but the car be sitting in the middle of the tires. Okay. So but down low. So it's hung.
The
it's
tires
slung.
Are higher than the car.
Tires are higher than the car. And the tires drag the car along the ground.
Okay. All right.
So the car
dropped. What the got it dropped. I don't understand.
I'm having even a harder time
the
understanding.
The car got a snow. They got like a train plow on the front.
Okay.
A cow pusher.
A train plow.
And so that digs into the streets.
Oh, I see. You're destroying the street.
It destroys in
street shark style.
And they stole the idea from me.
That's
what I was. Yeah. I was the first NIGFAG on the block that had a car.
Please stop saying that.
But I'm Chinese. I'm Mr. from Flourishing.
Yeah. That's
growing up in Flourishing. We would all call each other.
I think you're from upstate New York.
We would call. I'm first generation Taiwanese, so pardon me if I'm calling my friends NIGFAGs.
Okay. All right. Please stop.
I have a
it.
Question just to change tracks.
But
so candidate,
I
yeah.
said I was the first person to be destroying the streets with a bunch of sharks on top of my car.
Yeah.
And then that show came out, and I said, what? I said, hold on a damn minute, moaning.
So, candidate Yang, there's been a lot of.
I ain't seen nothing like that in the hot pot before. I mean, go ahead.
In the hot pot.
So I'm sorry.
There's been a lot of anti-Chinese and
That's
Asian
true.
Sentiment after the coronavirus, which as you
which,
know,
what are you talking about? I don't even know.
There was a virus that
uptick.
Came from Wuhan in China.
No, I don't know nothing about that shit. Anyway, so what we're trying to do is think about like eBay, but for pussy.
Woo! The crowd is going wild. Andrew Yang with a landslide victory in the mayoral primary with running on the platform of eBay for pussy.
Everybody trying to be a search worker right now, but... If you're trying to be a search worker and you ain't got your shit cert, then you in for suck. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. If you ain't cert, you suck.
That's true.
That's what I'm saying. Like, because we got a lot of, you know, they be thinking that people outside of New York be thinking that's for Jews only.
Right.
Uh-huh. But, you know, the reality is it increases the sensation.
Not getting cert.
Yeah.
Okay, I love it. Andrew Yang, everyone who's from
look, if you got,
Baltimore look, and Oakland, it look, sounds like at the same time.
Let me explain something to you.
Yes.
Look, you got a hat on and uh-huh. you go outside. How's that feel on your head? The weather, the wind. Imagine wind is
I can't really
pussy.
Feel the wind.
Imagine wind. You
if
can't
you're
feel
wearing
your head.
Okay, so the wind is
but
pussy.
You take the hat off. And now you got pussy all over your motherfucking face.
Oh, the wind is pussy
dripping down
but I
on
thought,
your shirt.
Which sounds awesome.
That's why I want to take it a step further. I'm trying to get all the skin taken off my penis entirely.
Oh, wow, that sounds painful.
I'm trying to have my shit inside her.
I thought you were for you were against circumcision.
I've changed my mind.
Okay,
so somebody said, it. Look, somebody sent me some literature on the issue, and now my position has changed,
has evolved.
You could even say my position has become circumcised.
Oh, okay, all right.
It's been turned inside her
because of the metaphor of a hat on your head. Head and wind being pussy. Is that what turned it around?
I don't even
you?
Think about it because that's how you know Jews be doing that shit with everything. You know,
that's true.
You wear a hat to hide the fact that you're going bald.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so the Jews said, why don't we just cut it down to the part where you're actually bald?
Yes.
And then we can feel all
smart.
That pussy wind on our
on
ears,
our hair.
On our hair.
But not on our bald head. Where it would slide bald. Off.
You want the rest of the hair growing
you
wild.
Want the hair saturated
you want
pussy.
Just a wet pussy.
Yeah, like
head.
A small hat. Yeah, a small hat to cover
to
the
cover
bald
up
part.
The bald part.
Yeah.
Because pussy juice can be corrosive to the skin.
And they're just doing the same shit with the cocks.
That's awesome. You know what? Honestly, Mr. Yang, you have turned turned me around on that.
Yeah, I know we're
issue.
Supposed to be the moderators and be objective, but
between eBay for pussy and getting pussy juice,
he had me
juice,
at eBay for pussy.
He had me there as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, what about the issue of
child molestation?
Child molestation.
Yeah, what about
how
that
as about
an
issue?
We're like, no. Oh, my bus.
What do you mean? What is
my
your take?
My bus.
We no,
gotta my bus.
We got to bring
my bus. Move on, please.
Okay.
Next question.
What about an occupancy tax? Oh, is that your Nextel?
Where are you at?
Who's next telling you?
I'm sorry. I'm just, you know, my shit blowing up. I'm trying to, I'm not be trying to interrupt Mr. Kamala over here.
That's just, that's not, what do you mean, Mr. Kamala? That's just a black guy.
I'm just trying to, you know, my shit be blowing up, but it's just different business.
Yeah, Mr. Kamala in real life is a Jewish guy. It's not even a black guy like he. Never mind.
Wait, is there a guy named Mr. Kamala?
In this situation, I'm on a debur stage, and we're debating, and I'm interrupting somebody's answer by pretending girls are blowing up my phone.
Oh, I see, So it's not girls.
It's not, the phone's
it's
not
guys?
Even me. It's me making noise.
You're calling yourself.
Me making a noise with my mouth.
What do you have to say?
Thanks for being honest.
Mr. Yang, please wait.
My shit blurring up.
It's not blurring up,
it's blurring up.
We can see your phone. It is not lighting up.
And it's bitches that got they pussy hard from my pernis. That might not sure well with some of you.
But I'll tell you, Mr. Yang, where did you pick this accent up from exactly, and what is it?
Yeah,
is
this...
It's a traditional Taiwanese accent.
Oh, this is from Taiwan.
Yeah, I'm from Taiwan.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, I had no idea. I had no idea, sir.
Yeah, the doctor says it's brain cancer. The doctor says I got a benign tumor that's grown to half the size of my skull.
Wow.
But it's benign.
Right. I told him benign. How about you suck this benign and a half?
That's very funny.
Thank you, Mr. Yang.
I'll give him that. That's very funny. But he's got problems with redistricting. So you shouldn't vote for that man.
Okay. Okay, okay. How many motherfuckers are running?
I'm bringing back bananas in pajamas, but this time you can see they're circumcised.
You can see their penises.
The top of the
now let me ask you
this.
Peeled
the
down
top
a
of the
bit.
Banana been peeled down.
Oh, so wait. They're all you're telling me you're revealing that the bananas in pajamas are actually two cocks, two giant cocks.
No, they're bananas.
Oh.
But it's a metaphor.
I see.
That's what makes art good.
Do you think some people might think what you're saying is
like
that bananas are penises?
Look, so like if I just said, oh, it's about a Polar Express, it's about a train that goes to the North Pole, that would be gay. But when you say the train is actually about like the mentality of lifestyles, that's how you know.
Are you a big Robert Zemeckis animation fan?
That's how you know it's a genius. That's the dollar bill cash mentality.
Dollar bill cash money mentality, of course.
Wow.
It's about executive styles of life management.
Between that's the dollar bill cash money mentality and being Chinese and saying the N-word, that locks up a lot of New York.
Yeah.
And if he flips on circumcision, that's three of the biggest.
Then you got the Orthodox Jews.
You got Jews, you got Chinese
teenagers.
You know
what I'm saying? You know, they got circumcision, but I'm trying to get smirk-umcision. I'm trying to get
smirk-umcision. Like a smile.
Like so you want a smile?
Yeah, I said carve my shit up so it looks like my dick is like, what's up, man?
It's smirking.
Hey, how you doing, man?
You want your penis?
I got my shit smirk-umcised.
You want your penis to look like
they cut
Heath
the
Ledger and the Joker without his makeup?
So the lip, the hole, the slit, it's got one, it's like the cheeks coming up on one. Inside and say, hey, I see you.
Oh, and that way you'll come in sort of a crescent moon shape.
Yeah, and I got on the side like a shark mouth tattooed on
me. Oh, yeah, you're into sharks. And then
like a Sailor Jerry, like a girl.
Yeah.
That says it ain't over till the fat lady serves.
Oh, wow. But she's not fat, the girl.
Yeah, the girl saying
she's fine as shit.
I'm
she's
fucking fine. That's the girl. Yeah. I'm fucking the fine girl. The fat bitch is just, she's some bitch.
She sings.
That's how you know when shit's done. Because back in the day in the factory, they used to hire a fat bitch to sing at the end of the day.
Oh.
That's where that expersion.
That's when it was quitting time.
That's where that expersion comes
from. The expersion.
The expersion, because it was the boss's wife. Because she'd be like, hey, I'm thinking about becoming like a celebrity and trying to sing. And she would try, and everybody would be like, we got to get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, that's annoying.
This fat bitch, ain't nobody trying to fuck her ass, and now she pretends she's talented. She pretended she talented instead of just.
I had no idea.
Just big.
Thank you, Mr. Yang. Once again, you've gone over your time by 45 minutes. No one is here anymore. It's just...
All right, don't forget that shit. The most important takeaway, I invented street sharks.
Damn, it would be awesome if
if that's what Andrew Yang sounded like, mm-hmm. then then I would vote for him.
Oh, do you remember when definitely. Andrew Yang was first running and I did a Chinese voice and you were like, is that what he sounded
yeah,
like?
Yeah, I never heard him talk. It was possible.
Oh, what was it? Something embarrassed.
No, it's not possible.
Nick was doing like his hardcore Chinese accent.
Say, it's not.
You know, why is it not possible?
Because it's not possible.
You guys are racist for thinking that, not me. Mm-hmm. I'm the kind of guy that thinks America's ready for a guy that talks like that to be president.
I don't know if we are.
You're not.
I'm ready. I'm ready. I don't know if America's ready.
That's the kind of guy I am, though, that I'm giving America the benefit of the doubt.
Well, I'm ready to hear his voice and then know what it sounds like.
Who the fuck else is running for mayor?
Some chicks.
Oh, nice. Are they?
They better.
Suck on my dick. I'm gay. Suck on my dick. Cool. This fuck on my ass. My pain is as small. You're gonna suck into my dick.
Sometimes if I fart and it's like a long, squeaky one, I'll say, ooh, barracuda, at the end. And I don't know why. It doesn't have any relation to the song.
They hit that a couple times.
Oh, barracuda.
I don't know why. It doesn't sound like that.
They hit something in that tenor a couple times in the song.
Do they?
Not right before barracuda, but yeah,
depends
it's there.
What kind of fart.
Something like that.
Gay ass song. That's about a fish.
About a barracuda, but a like, scary fish though.
Wait, barracudas are fish?
Yeah,
they're violent.
The fuck do you think it was? Some type of cat?
I thought it was like a fucking like a Tasmanian devil type of thing. I swear to God, I thought it was. Doesn't it sound like a furry type
Come
of
on,
Wolverine
bro.
Type of thing?
You never watched Legend of the Hidden Temple?
You're thinking of a Wolverine.
I guess now that you're saying that, I am thinking of a Wolverine.
No, a hundred.
But
badger.
You know what I thought? It was something in between Wolverine and like badger.
No,
a barracuda was like a smaller
like
Wolverine,
like a
kind of Tasmanian devil, type.
A fierce fish.
They're like piranha.
Oh, yeah. That's funny.
They're like a long.
They have like a snout.
Piranha.
Yeah,
that
yeah.
does suck. Dude.
You don't remember Legends of the Hidden Temple? The blue barracudas.
No, none of us watched it. You're the only one who watched baby
I watched,
shows.
I did watch that, but I was not paying attention.
And I was accusing my cat of watching baby shows while I was gone, and that was making me laugh. Like, what are you doing? Just watching fucking Arthur and Barney in here? Fucking loser.
Fucking idiot. The cat's
meow. Yeah, the cat has
begging
no
for food.
Yeah.
You're like, you don't get
begging
food
for
you
attention
because you watch baby shows.
Instead of me doing bits at the cat that it doesn't understand.
And the cat's not even paying attention.
Who knows, man? Maybe the cat does understand.
Look at this motherfucker.
Oh, that's what a barracuda is, huh?
Let me see it. Wow, scary.
I got to say, I think it should be an animal with fur.
Or, well, write,
claws.
Write a letter to God.
A barracuda, I will.
One of those. There was like one of those medical mystery shows where they like somebody's like all fucked up, and there was some guy that went to the hospital. They couldn't figure out what was wrong with him. It took like 2 days to figure out that he had just like eaten a barracuda that he caught.
Oh shit!
And got like a
bad for you.
We got like a barracuda parasite.
Oh,
but they're like, is there anything like I don't know what it could be? And he's like, well, I guess I ate this weird fish.
Are you not supposed to eat barracudas?
I think there's a lot of shit you're not supposed to just eat.
Mm, interesting.
Yeah.
Why? It's a fucking fish. You chop it up?
Because it's dangerous. It's a dangerous fish.
I don't give a fuck.
Obviously, if it got that powerful, you have nature decided that it is to be respected.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's nothing more delicious than fucking forbidden flesh.
Yeah, they don't have predators because they
we should have tried
taste like shit.
Fugu when we were in Japan.
Oh, puffer fish?
Yeah.
Yeah, we should.
Hell yeah, dude. That
you
was
think
a,
it's delicious?
That's awesome.
Instead of doing the only thing I did while I was there, which is buy Kit Kats that I thought were special in Japan, but it turns out they sell them.
The green tea?
You know, they do the green tea ones are here, but there are plenty of ones you can only get in Japan.
Like what?
They love Kit Kats.
You know that for
there.
A fact?
Yes.
Yeah, they have a million.
We're gonna bring you over all the.
I mean,
Kit
I suppose
Kats.
You could order them off the.
And
internet.
This is brought to you by BlueChew.com.
Blurcher.
Let me make sure it's brought to you because I gotta start doing this by the. Yeah, it is by BlueChew.com.
Yeah, this shit is brought to you by motherfucking BlueChew.com.
My penis doesn't work.
Put your phone down.
I'm looking for the read.
No, you're not.
Yeah.
You're checking your fucking.
No.
You're checking your fucking portfolio.
No, Nick sent us the read.
If you check your penis twice a day for cancer, you should check your penis 17 times a day.
With the man's mouth.
With BlueChew.com, if you like sex, you love sex.com.
You love sex. If you love sex.
If you love BlueChew, you'll love sex.com. BlueChew.com.
What do you think sex.com's got on it? Absolutely.
You never checked it when you were like 11?
I've never checked sex.com.
That was like the first website I checked.
I checked tits.com first. No, that was my first step.
Sex.com was the first one I checked.
Nah, dude. That's why you don't have any imagination. You got to go tits.com. And I was caught, in fact, at the Roland Park Middle School computer lab looking up tits.com. Oh, hell yeah.
It's just...
What's that?
It's sex.com.
That's awesome.
Oh, nice, dude.
Mm-hmm. I'm actually kind of... I'm actually just got a little jump in my cock.
A woman's pussy. if it changed.
Let's look at sex.com.
I have to say, I'm rock hard right now because I took a blue chew this morning.
Yes, exactly. And you, so you just take the blue chew.
Oh, nice.
Check out
now,
sex.com.
Now, what you doing with that gigantic dildo? That thing must be 6'5" What kind of human pussy can take all that? I don't like that kind of pornography.
That's fake.
What is that? A whole 5.5 to 6.25-inch dildo?
Yeah, it's not massive. Real.
That's disgusting.
So big. It's disgusting.
They're blowing out that woman's pussy.
That dildo must be.
She's
like
gonna have incontinence problems from now on.
Yeah, she'll never be the same.
If you like BlueChew.com, you should check out BlueChew.com.
You should check out BlueChew. If you like to get your dick hard and in a pussy or an ass or a mouth,
mm-hmm.
or in between a fucking feet or an armpit, whatever the fuck you're into, and you're mad, you're.
You like sex.
Go to cum.town and then from there buy a shirt.
Don't do your own read in the middle of the read.
They're not gonna
but
like
they're
that.
Different things. If you wear a cum.town shirt while eating the blue
okay,
shirt,
put on the shirt mm-hmm.
and then buy the shirt and then nut
open
into
up
the shirt.
Internet Explorer.
Beat off
and while you're
then,
online.
And then go to stavi.biz where there's other shirts that you can also buy.
And if you want to go to BlueChew.com. You can check out, there are two drugs that they sell.
Yep.
Sildenafil.
And Tadalafil.
One of them is for Sicilians and the other is for homosexuals.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You figure out which.
Ta-da.
The secret is they're both the same pill.
Ta-da.
Oh, Tadalafil is for gay magicians who can't get hard.
Well, that's what they say. They take their preps and they go, ta-da. I'm all cured.
Mm-hmm. Listen, folks, we have a good time. We joke around in here, but in all seriousness, Tadalafil and Sildenafil are fucking Cialis and Viagra.
Yeah,
the
listen
same
to
active
us. We're being
ingredients.
Serious.
We're being serious here, and you're going to want to take those to get your prick hard as fuck.
The BlueChew.com affiliated physicians will suck you off.
You'll show them a picture of your cock. They'll try with all their might to get it hard, and if they can't, that's the test. They've hired Corinne Superhead Stevens on the BlueChew.com staff.
Trubles.
She sucks your cock. If it doesn't get hard, you get the pills for free.
Trubles can work faster. The Trubles from BlueChew.com take on a full or empty stomach. Online physician consult is free, so it's super intuitive.
Mm-hmm.
Only takes a few minutes to connect to BlueChew.com. Affiliated physicians isn't qualified. You can prescribe online quickly.
So true.
No person doctor visit, no all conversation with a live pharmacy.
None of that stuff.
Sex really adored in discreet packaging.
That's right. Discreet.
What if I just started getting drunk just for the reads?
That would be awesome.
Yeah, and
then we stop
up.
The episode, then let me sleep for 12 hours.
Yeah, have a coffee.
Just like a flight.
Put a fucking, yeah.
Are we ready to do the rest of the show? Yes, we are. Yes, I am. Did I crash that plane? Yes, I did, and I'll do it again.
What was flight? He did crash it, but
he
did
crashed
it with
a plane
hard dick
on purpose to get his
people.
Penis hard because it makes him come.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Blue Chew gives you confidence in bed every time. You and your partner will love it. Chew it and do it.
That's so fucking true.
It only takes a few minutes to connect with a BlueChew.com.
Let me tell you, I've had sex with Blue Chew. I've had sex without Blue Chew.
Same.
And I've shoved it in my
ass. And women much prefer when I take
and
Blue Chew.
And women think his dick sucks.
Without Blue Chew, yes.
Without it, and then he takes it and they say
they don't even try and say they also think it sucks. Still.
Hold on, let me go over here.
Do it.
They say it sucks.
What the fuck? I can hear you, Michael Douglas.
Why? What do you mean?
But it's sexy. Say it. But
I'm whispering. I'm doing it behind his back. You can't hear me. Listen here.
Where'd gay Michael Douglas
just
go?
Just let him talk.
Just wait one.
Do you know where he went?
He's whispering.
And I'll tell you.
What's he whispering?
We saw.
I don't know.
His,
I can't hear.
We saw his dick, and it was the smallest dick I've ever seen.
I can't hear what you're saying, but it feels like he's lying.
I watched The China Syndrome the other day.
Did you do it by going to bluechew.com and using promo code?
Promo code
Cumtown.
Cumtown or Cumtown 20. Or and you just have to pay shipping on your first
and
order.
And it's free. Your cock gets hard for free.
For free. $5 for shipping. That's bluechew.com. So promo code Cumtown. Michael Douglas is in China Syndrome.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. And, I was watching Richard Jewell at the time first. Nice. I watched Richard Jewell and I said, how about Richard Drool? And it's about a retarded guy that finds
a bomb at Millennium Park?
No. Please, come on.
Sorry.
Yeah. I start the joke.
All right. I didn't mean to say
and
that.
Then you derail it by saying what
just
Richard
the plot. Just the full straight
well,
on
it would
plot.
Be a mashup because it would be a retarded guy that finds the
it's
bomb.
A retarded guy that finds choking hazards at the Special
okay.
Olympics.
Okay. That's better. That's better.
You didn't even consider that's the Olympics
better.
Angle.
Yeah, that's better.
Because Richard Jewell's about the, what is it, Adam?
Richard Jewell. Well, anyways, I said that to my dad.
That was creative. That was inventive.
And he didn't respond. And then I was watching China Syndrome, and I said, "How about China Syndrome?" But they get to the titular line where the scientist looks at Jane Fonda, and he goes, "They call it the China Syndrome." She says, "Why do they call it that?" He goes, "Because you'd have to be a fucking mongoloid to let that happen."
That's funny.
I'm not familiar with the film, but
oh, it's good. Michael Douglas is in. He plays a cameraman.
Nice.
I've got this tape you got to see.
It's a woman sucking my penis.
I kept the camera rolling while we were in the nuclear reactor, and I went into the bathroom, and I made a video of me and Jack Lemmon having sex.
Damn, what do you think would happen if you had gay sex in a nuclear reactor? You think it would make you even gayer?
No. Creates a China Syndrome. Wilford Brimley's in that movie, too.
Oh, what is the China Syndrome?
I'm not a Navy guy. I've been a company man 30 years. You tell me how to have gay sex. He's good in that.
I don't think I've seen it. What happens?
I haven't seen it.
If they ever made a Chapo movie, Wilford Brimley from 40 years ago should play Matt Christman.
Plays Matt?
Yeah.
That's good casting.
Yeah.
That's dream casting.
Mm-hmm.
If they made a Cumtown movie, we would have...
Nancy Pelosi's a cunt. She's got a vagina vetus. She's got a vagina vetus. Your lancets, your medications, delivered directly to your door.
Oh, I see. Vagina vetus is diabetes.
When you got a penis.
Oh, yeah.
If you got diabetes.
Diabetes.
Have you got a guy penis?
A guy has penis.
Yeah.
Well, the only thing I love more than oatmeal is getting fucked in my ass.
Did he love oatmeal?
He was that was his thing before Liberty Mutual.
Really?
He was the oatmeal guy.
I had no idea.
You don't remember that?
I remember him solely from Liberty Mutual and diabetes.
Liberty.
Oh, wow. Liberty came up, huh? Because now they're everywhere. They got that emu. Or no, is that a different guy?
Mm-hmm.
Who fucking cares? Fuck commercials.
Yeah. I don't care about any commercials. Dude, other than BlueChew.com.
The only commercials I care about
eating
are BlueChew.com.
Eating oatmeal is the only thing I know how to do.
And some other commercial in about 15 minutes, probably.
You know, when I was a kid and got a hold of a nickel, I thought I was rich. I didn't turn up my nose at pennies either. Today, some folks won't even bend to pick them up.
I remember this ad.
Because I fucked
them. Well, here's
a
bowl of steaming Quaker oatmeal. And I can't think of a healthier way to start the day. Cost you one nickel and 4 pennies. So if you can't be bothered with nickels and pennies, throw them in a jar. Start an oatmeal fund. Quaker Oats.
That is such
a right
sad thing to do.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, back when they invented pennies, I mean, what the fuck is that?
That is such a depressing
Are you so poor your breakfast needs to cost 9 cents?
What are you, a
Quaker Oats? Damn, dude.
Back when I was a kid.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't want some oatmeal right now.
I'm not an oatmeal guy.
I love oatmeal.
I like it when you dress it up, you know, with some fruits.
That's one of the things I miss.
I miss about being
on the road is you wake up at some shitty motel and you go downstairs and you mix the oatmeal with Trix? With Activia.
You make
a nice big bowl of Activia oatmeal.
That sounds horrible. See, I'm over here eating fucking 4 of those Danishes, pre-wrapped Danishes.
I was on the road with Lewis and Dave one time, and we borrowed Bobby's car, and I drove to Detroit for them in Bobby's car.
I remember that. You had that fucking show in a strip club?
Yeah, and it was like, I drove like fucking maybe 7 hours at night.
Oh, Jesus.
And we got to the motel like way late. And Lewis was like about to get into a fight with the guy at the Like, Lewis was immediate as soon as we get there. He's like, what do you mean the fucking rooms aren't, you know? And the guy's like, we don't have reservations. It's like it's some shitty motel. And he's like, bro, you're going to find a fucking... And so I'm like, I'm not. And I just immediately, because I'm like, I'm figuring they're going to call the cops and we're going to have to leave. So I just like went to the breakfast area and started eating right before anything could
happen.
And then eventually got resolved. And Lewis comes over and he's like, what are you doing? You're an animal. And I'm like, me? You're about to hate crime this Indian man. I'm just trying to get free kicks.
You're about to just cause the overnight man guy who works the desk at a Holiday Inn.
Yeah.
Dude, that motel was such a dump. They had like, you know, like some places you go, it's like, feel free to take our towels, but keep in mind there's a service charge for them. So this place had one of those signs, but it was like had a listing of prices and the towels are like $25.
Hilarious.
But then it's like the TV is $500. Yeah. Like the mirror in the bathroom is a price.
Yeah, dude.
They were probably people probably just that's a real Andrew Yang move is to keep the TV from a hotel room.
Yeah.
What a funny thing to do. Like they're not gonna notice.
Well,
they'll be like, huh.
I think if you're doing that, you're just trashing it, right? No one's stealing TVs from a hotel room, are they? I think you're just getting fucked up off fucking...
You want this Magnavox from 1989?
Yeah. You need this fucking ray tube TV.
What's that?
Cathode ray tube. Cathode?
Is that the name? I forget.
Yeah, she's one of the cooking women.
Cathode ray?
Yeah, Kathy Ray tube.
Oh, yeah, I know
Kathy
her.
Ray tube.
Yeah. Y'all, we're making chocolate cocks filled with...
Cathode with ray tube.
With a Bernays.
Yummy.
Yeah.
Oh, I want to suck. I want to get my dick sucked by Kathy tube.
Kathy tube. What's the wish?
She would be so nice about sucking your dick. Mm. She'd be nice to you after she sucked it.
Oh, she'd love it, dude. She's a kind
she'd
of
be like, thank you.
Joanne Fabrics vibes.
Are women not normally nice to you afterwards?
No,
they're like, get out, Adam.
Yeah. She'd be like, thank you for the cum.
That was delicious.
That was great.
Get out of my high school.
Get out.
Get out.
You don't even go here.
Get out of Benjamin Netanyahu Elementary School.
Hey,
right now
I am going to report you if you don't leave the Gold of My Ear auditorium right this instant.
I'm the club advisor for the comedy club here at Benjamin Netanyahu Elementary. Okay? I'm trying to bolster my resume at 33 by helping out after school teaching them comedy.
I got to give it to Israel in terms of that they did do some impressive wars. I got to admit.
Six-Day War.
The Six-Day War is pretty cool. Now, I wish they didn't do genocide right after that, but the war itself, you got to give them props for that.
The war on getting Percy?
The war on getting Percy.
My friend's name is Percy. I'm like, come on, bro. That can't be your real name.
Yeah. that guy, that character, this weird version of Andrew Yang getting mad because he saw the movie Percy Jackson.
Yeah, and it's not
like,
about
what
getting
what the hell
Percy.
Is this? I thought I was about to watch Samuel L. Jackson get Percy.
Yeah, I'm trying to have Percy, an evening with some Percy.
What do you guys think of this for... a phrase to say that you are a Vietnam veteran.
Mm-hmm. Like
you got pussy in Vietnam.
Vietnam.
But you weren't in the war. You just went to Vietnam to get pussy.
You just went for the vibes.
For the vibes, dude. Vietnam, I bet you the Vietnamese vibes are pretty good right now.
Over there, right now? Yeah, it's probably great.
They probably locked the fuck down.
Probably better than here.
Probably don't have coronavirus, and you get a big bowl of pho, some spring rolls, get your dick sucked pretty cheap on the cheap.
Go ride a rickshaw.
That'd be awesome. Go to Ho Chi Minh City, get some pussy.
I would love that. That's such a good name for a place.
Ho Chi Minh City, bro. I'm about to grow his facial hair, start wearing a little hat like that.
You should get a Fu Manchu.
Stavros Chi Minh. Stav Chi Minh.
You could look a little Asian, actually.
Scrooge.
When I went to Popular Jewelry to fucking get a couple...
They thought you were Chinese?
They asked me if I was Chinese.
That's so sick. You should have said yes for the discount.
I should have.
For the family discount.
I feel like now, though... Growing out my hair, I look much more Greek. I feel like this is the haircut of Greek excellence, a balding long flow.
Actually, that's true. I had a guy on my old apartment on my block That was a like a buzz cut, fat Asian, like Chinese guy. He looked a lot like you, actually.
Yeah, buzz cuts are the great equalizer with a fat guy. A lot of fat people just look good. You can either look Chinese. If you're fat, if your cheeks go a certain way, it gives you a little Asiatic flavor, I think it's safe to say.
I'm going to tug butt cheer.
Let's hear it.
No, I got nothing on that one.
Tug right. butt cheer?
Sorry, I'm going to have to make a coffee real quick.
Okay. Yeah. Why don't you drink the coffee you have there?
I already finished it.
You really are a coffee addict. You're addicted to Java.
Well, you got to understand, it's like something's got a power. I just...
The machine.
I just did a flawless Andrew Yang impression.
That was really good.
That was really
and
good.
And to stay on note, I mean, you got to...
They
really
should give us credit for...
For what?
You really need drugs to get the to get going.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you should do drugs, dude.
Butt cheeks.
Butt cheeks.
Butt cheeks.
Don't you understand? His cheeks have been clapped. Wiggly.
Someone clapped his cheeks. Ah, oh, fuck.
Are you telling me?
She scratched you?
Sorry, dude.
Oh, her shit's all over my jacket, man.
Somebody told me.
Come on, man.
Are you going to complain about the cat?
Do you see my eyes right now?
You're the one we were supposed to do this at your apartment, but you said we have to do it.
We can do it at mine, dude. I'm so allergic to this fucking cat.
We had to switch it to yours.
I had to move for 1 week. We can go back to mine. It's fine. We can use the living room. We have three chairs there.
I'm gonna keep.
I won't have to sit on a box anymore. I've been sitting on a box the last 3 weeks.
If you say another word, I'm gonna kill your dog with Brazilian jiu-jitsu moves.
No, you can kill my dog anyway.
Why don't you fucking hang up your fucking coat next time, bro?
Where does he have a hang for that?
He has a claw. He's a coat closet.
Oh, that's true.
Put your fucking phone away. He's going to make coffee.
Check my money.
I had to check my money.
The anyway, wolf, the can wolf you just, of Wall Street.
Can you just, okay. Stop. Do you see how much hair there is on that jacket?
I'm not.
That's a disrespectful amount of hair.
Oh my God.
That is a Nick amount of hair.
Shed all
if
over
Nick
your
did
shirt.
That, he'd be like, I don't know what you're talking about.
That's pretty funny.
Oh my gosh. Okay, anyway, we'll deal with that after the show. You have a lint roller, Nick? He's not answering me.
It is so funny you're allergic to cats. I forgot.
I hate it, dude. I hate these cocksuckers. I think I'm allergic to my dog anyway, but I can't get rid of her.
You're allergic to your dog?
I love her too much. Sometimes her fur makes me itch. My
when
skin.
You put it, when you put her tail
when
in
I have
your
sex
ass?
With her. when I have sex with her.
You use her fucking tail as a dildo?
Well, her tail is... she can move it in four different directions, so... It's better than a real penis.
Do you think you could train her to hit your G-spot with her tail?
Do you think I could?
Have you ever had your prostate stimulated, Adam?
I had a prostate exam once, and
was the doctor finger fucking you?
The doctor presses on your prostate.
Okay,
and he said, and I was an old man. He said, "This is gonna feel like you need to pee," and it really does.
Wow,
I wouldn't say it was pleasant.
You think if he worked it a little better, it would have felt good?
I don't know. That's what gay guys, I guess, that's the ultimate for them is feeling like they need to pee.
Really?
From some guy's fingers in their ass.
Is that the ultimate gay guy desire?
I don't know. Getting your ass stimulated? I assume
you feel like you need to pee?
I assume that's the point.
Yeah, I guess so. Unless you like
based
to stimulate the asses.
Based on my limited
asses.
Experience of having things in my ass, that you know, seems to be the point of
32,
of gay.
Right? Being 32, I think it's time I got the Stifler treatment and got finger fucked by a hot lady.
Got milked?
Why not?
Why not?
At this point, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, I'm not opposed to it, but based on that doctor's
visit, it sounds like you are. It sounds like you're a fucking coward.
I'm not a homophobe, and I'm not a coward.
You're both.
I'm both.
You're a coward who's scared of gay men.
Yeah. It's true. The hatred shouldn't be phobe. It should be a different word.
Uh-oh, here we go.
Yeah, thank
go
you.
Go off. This is your ISO. This is your ISO.
This is my observational
you
bit.
Get 30 more seconds.
Mm. Okay, so if I'm a homophobe, that means I'm just like, ah, spooky.
Oh,
yeah,
I'm
yeah.
scared. That's really good.
Should
it's
be
something
a better,
I haven't heard before.
Yeah.
I've definitely never heard that
phrase. Yeah. Thanks.
By the way, Nick said it's an original bit, everyone.
I probably
from his kitchen.
I mean, first of all, is it not? It's not an original bit. Second of all, I've probably said it three times on this show, and
you
it's probably
stolen it already.
And that's probably, and that's you guys probably came back with that. I feel like we're just living in a groundhog.
I think it's a good premise.
Thank you, dude.
Let's see. I had some thoughts about something that I wanted to bring up on the show, but I forgot.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I want to say I'm jealous of Joe Biden, dude.
Why? Because he gets to just be
his
wheeled
life
around,
rocks, dude. Yeah, he doesn't know where the fuck he is.
Yeah.
All he did was get one cool black friend. If you get a black friend cool enough, all your dreams can come true.
I don't know. I think all those little kids at the pool.
I don't think they're friends.
I think they were all his friends.
What was the guy's name? Slipknot or Blackjack?
Corn Pop.
Corn Pop.
I think Corn Pop was probably his friend.
I guess that's true. He made two cool black friends, Corn Pop and Barry O.
Yeah. No, his granddaughter posted a picture of him from President's Day where they bought him a bunch of stuff that says that he's the president on it, like a president hat.
To remind him.
And a president jacket and stuff, and he looks so utterly confused.
Yeah, dude.
Like, happy President's Day, we got you all this cool swag.
Yeah.
And he looks like he does not know where he is.
I love him, dude. Yeah. I wish that was my fucking life. You just accidentally fail into your career dream.
Come on, man! I'm the president. That's my daughters. They got me a Delta. It's got a.
It has the seal.
It says Ask Force One.
That'd be cool.
A big long Delta says Ask Force One on the side. And when you sit down on a 15-inch Delta. But the second it reaches your brain, that's how you get the thinking started. That's I couldn't think about anything until I sat on that big cock.
Big cock.
I put the big cock in my ass.
It would be awesome if he just had a fucking plug in at all times.
I plug up.
He's got a plug and two nipple rings.
The American people want to see a big cock in my ass.
I hope they let him do an audio book.
Yeah,
I think he'd be
awesome.
I think he'd be a good narrator.
One fish, two fish, red fish, bull fish. That's two different fish.
He's got two fish.
There's guy down the street selling fish. Went over there and said, "Why don't you give me a fucking hand job?"
Chapter two.
If you want curses,
we can either bust that.
There's a guy named Dickhead Faggot. His dad owned a railroad. And we would all go over to his house and we'd compare our dick sizes. And I remember there was a guy named Big Cock Larry. And we thought he had the biggest cock, but he pulled his pants down to his regular size.
Wow.
And turns out it was actually a mongoloid that had the biggest one. Mm-hmm. Anyways,
if you like Joe Biden, you can find out more about him at MacWeldon.com.
They have a tab.
Go to MacWeldon. Go to the Joe Biden tab.
MacWeldon.com/Joe Biden.
Mac Touches. MacWeldon.com/touch me. Mm-hmm. Touch me.
Touch my dick. If you suck my honk, then I'll fuck your ass. You can make me come.
You can fuck my ass. You can fuck my ass. Fuck me in my ass.
Why don't you suck me there?
Suck my dick. I can't wait to get fucked in my ass.
I'm fucking gay. My dick is small.
Let's see.
Stuff my pussy.
MacWeldon, they got a simple Pratt fabrics here.
I love simple fabrics.
I hate when they get too complicated.
Simple fabrics for simple minds. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you what, I had to buy some long johns recently.
I have some long johns from MacWeldon,
and it was such a pain in the ass to have to go figure out how to buy them. I ended up just completely nude in the middle of Fifth Avenue.
That's right.
With a
shouting, a snowbank,
a sandwich board that said "I hate the N word,"
right?
You know, and then I trying to explain to everyone, it's like, no, I hate when people say it. I'm not.
Can't you see the quotation marks around it?
Yeah.
It's because someone's saying it. That's what I hate.
What a cool scene in a movie.
It is pretty good.
We found it, MacWeldon. We did, because we wanted more out of our basics and always questioned how something so essential could be such a pain in the ass to buy.
Thank you. I've been questioning that for years, bro.
Yeah, that's a good question.
The frustration was real.
And the eureka moment happened in a department store aisle full of brands that dominated our top drawers, surrounded by a mind-numbing assortment of underwear and socks. We realized consistent fit.
Adam, quality. Stay on your box, please.
No, my box is hurting my butt.
Stay on your box. You're fucking up the feng shui, dude.
No, no, I'm looking at you like this.
You're not even looking at
you. You guys are so comfortable on the couch. I have to sit on this box.
You're looking at him the way Kate looks at Jack in Titanic.
Hornily.
Yeah.
With your pussy fucking dripping.
Yeah.
Your pussy saturated.
Why don't you tell them about the long underwear you guys?
Well, let me say this. I, for years, was pretending I had ever worn Mack Weldon's. But recently...
They really are. I literally am. Look, I'll prove it. I'm wearing them right now.
I know you are. Let me see. Am I?
Let me see. Just a little bit lower. It looks like a vagina. That looked... I mean, I just...
I pulled my pubic hair out. Yes, I trimmed my
pubes. You pulled your pubic hair?
Yes, I trimmed my pubes. What am I, a fucking animal?
You ripped them out?
I don't trim my pubes
at all. No, I use a Norelco One Blade to give it a little
once over. No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you use...
I don't think we've gotten money from anybody else in a while, so...
Okay, yeah.
I've used the Norelco One Blade, thank you very much. Until the check clears, that's what I use.
Mack Weldon.
Mack Weldon, on the other
hand. The underwear is really nice. In fact, I'm like, they keep sending me a promo code that, like, a one for us that just gets.
Yeah,
it.
Why can't I get that?
They get, shut up.
I've never gotten it either.
They get it for free, but then.
One for you, you mean?
Well, they send it to me because it's always been
done
to the media company.
I think Nick deserves it. He fucking does all the ads.
He negotiates.
He deserves the free underwear. Well, you can buy your own fucking underwear.
Yeah.
I will.
You can go to MackWeldon.
How about I buy you some damn underwear?
How about you buy me some underwear? You go to MackWeldon.com, promo code, what is it?
Cumtown 20
or Cumtown. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I bought the long underwear.
Cumtown 20. Yes.
I love it. I've been going on walks. Everyone knows. Everyone by this point must be acquainted with the fact that I am the 20,000 step bastard, and I get around 9 to 10 miles a day walking on most days. In the winter, that's difficult to do. I bought some cheap fucking bullshit long johns. They would bunch my nuts up. I would get fucking
itchy. Some of those guys
it
get
was
itchy.
Horrible.
Yeah,
I said to myself, what the fuck am I doing? We got a fucking sponsor here that makes underwear so beautiful it'll make you cry.
Yeah, honestly,
you
know,
let me
annoying.
Buy it.
When I run out of Mack Weldon underwear and I have to go back to wearing my other underwear,
sucks
before
dick.
Doing laundry, it makes me pissed off.
It pisses me the fuck off.
It makes me really fucking angry.
Me yeah. too.
And he takes it out on the people in his life.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
The fuck are you talking about?
Stop it, dude.
Don't interrupt me on a good underwear day.
I'm sorry.
I got my Mack Weldon underwear
Nick,
on.
Come on, let him
come
go.
Come on, cool out, cool out.
Leave the kid alone. He doesn't know what he's doing.
Cool on out, cool
I'm
on out, dude.
Ready to bring a gun to the Palisades Mall. And show everyone.
That would be awesome.
I was watching. Yeah. Never mind.
What? Yeah,
on bet. The local news, there was a savage attack in a Brooklyn mall the other day.
And really? Then,
yeah, they said that before. Damn, the commercial.
Was it a guy wearing Vanguard News Network?
Was it a savage attack? Was it a guy wearing Rihanna's lingerie line?
I don't know. Oh, the Savage Fenty? Dude,
which, by the way, of course
you
I
saw
did.
That pic, dude.
I would honestly, Adam, I would shoot you a point blank range to have sex with Rihanna.
I would die tomorrow for one sex
if you
with her.
If you wanna,
I would shoot your nose off with an elephant rifle to have sex with her.
I would shoot my own nose off.
What do you mean?
What do you mean? What do I mean?
Oh, sorry. I said what I was texting.
He literally did, folks. You might think Nick was joking. I saw him X out of his text box.
Yeah. Mack Weldon will be the most comfortable underwear, socks, shirts.
Comfortable, warm.
Hoodies and sweatpants and more that you will ever wear. I'm going to start talking like Spinner from Degrassi.
Well, I like that for you.
Dude, I've told multiple women, I've watched I've been watching Degrassi with strange women.
Nice.
And I love chicks.
Numerous people I've told that Spinner is the character is supposed to have Down syndrome.
Mm-hmm. And they believe it?
100% hit rate.
Nice.
I love that.
Yeah. They probably really believe it. They're not just like, why won't this guy shut the fuck up about Degrassi?
Yeah, no. It's the way I said it. I'm like, not the one that's...
They're like, uh-huh. They're putting their fucking shoes on after not coming.
You're fucking... you're confusing your dates when you're like
no,
showing
not.
Off your M&M collection. You're like, this is the blue one. He's the smart one.
First of all, I would eat my... Pick a side with me. me. If I'm so fat in your fucking little fantasies, I'm eating the fucking the M&M's before there's a chance.
The plushies that you
I would eat those two out of being confused and hungry. Thank you very much. This character of Stavros that you've created, you would accuse him of eating these plushies.
I crushed them.
Now who's mad about characters? Oh! Don't you try to instigate. You keep your
I don't know. I wasn't even paying attention to what you're saying. I was just,
Adam likes a little sparring match between the two titans of the podcast. Yeah. Mm-hmm. He's
Godzilla and Mothra going. Yeah.
And guess what I am?
He's a gay little Japanese guy going, yeah.
Godzilla, you have to stop Mothra.
I did good on Valentine's. I made spaghetti meatballs.
Nice, man.
Yeah.
Where did this? Who asked?
I just want my boys to know.
But what did that have to do with that?
Because we're talking about the empty women, the empty sex that we have.
I
don't even fuck anymore. I just force people to watch Degrassi.
I'm just saying, maybe you get a girlfriend, you make from scratch.
You made from scratch spaghetti?
Spaghetti and meatballs.
Nah, I'm not doing that shit.
Why?
That sounds kind of
I'm saying
nice.
I mix half pork, half ground beef. And you know what? Instead of milk,
half
you know what
Chinese.
I used ricotta. It was richer. And then I put a nice spice on the meatball.
You'll be richer if you put on Mack Weldon underwear.
True. Your dick will feel like $1 million.
And if you don't like it, you can...
Or your pussy.
If you don't like it, they'll refund you.
I like
your
that.
Order.
Yep.
And if you get...
They have a fucking...
What is it? You get...
No risk guarantee. You get
refund. 20. Yeah, the no risk guarantee. Something about, I think they send you free underwear on your birthday or something.
Yep.
That might be in there. That might be something. They got the Mack Weldon Loyalty Blue or something.
I love being a part of the Blue
You'll
Network.
You'll see it. Look, go there and you sign up for the Blue Network. And if you spend it... you sign up... And you get something like 20% off every order if you spend over $6 million.
Yeah, just like this.
And if
6 million yen, which is much lower.
$6 million in Japanese.
Which is what Mr. Yang wants to convert us to.
Andrew Slurin.
Andrew Slurin.
You gotta check out MerrickWeldon.com.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Andrew.
Damn.
Mm-hmm. Andrew Urin.
My name's Andrew Urin.
No, that's how we say it in Erkland.
In Erkland is Andrew Urin.
Interwern.
I love having wearing derpers. I love putting on my Mack Weldon derpers.
Mack Weldon should start doing diapers.
Derpers for wiggers.
Derpers
for workers. What did we miss here?
Spaghetti and meatballs.
Do not share promo code. Yep. 20% off your first order, Mackwell.com. What the fuck is this loyalty? Because that's the thing they want.
Okay. So yeah, we're so still doing
nice
the read, and I
want
to say
design premium.
I love the loyalty program.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a part of it.
Look, to be honest with you, I don't fuck around with any of that shit because I get the underwear for free.
But I do. Mm-hmm.
But here's,
and I say it's
here's
great.
How much I enjoy the underwear is that I've harassed the media company buyer for additional promo codes so I can get even more of it for free.
Sounds fair to me.
Yeah. But I would pay for it. It's just it would be foolish of me not to try and get
Nick something. Is a capitalist at heart.
At my heart, I'm a captain of industry.
And how you make money is begging for free stuff.
Capitalism, bad. Captainalism? Mm-hmm. Now, that's cool.
That is cool, dude.
It's going to be so funny how gay all of this...
Socialism is?
Yeah. Well, just the online world of... What are you doing?
It already
is. I'm just blocking
is.
Out the lights. I'm just playing like a little game.
What are you playing? What are you doing?
Okay, for the sometimes you literally have the mind of a
cat. No, that was like a cat. You were like a cat playing with a laser pointer just now,
bro. I didn't even plan. My body took over. I was like,
no. I mean, you're playing like a baby's game of object completion or whatever.
Yeah, I'm playing peekaboo with your lights. I like the orange hue. It's cool.
Yeah, it is nice. It's nice at night when I put on westerns. And
oh, hell yeah.
I love that.
In fact, you got the light bulbs that change colors?
Yeah, and I got blackout curtains, too. I can give you a little Sam Powell
after
this.
Very nice.
MackWeldon.com,
promo code cometown20 for
and sign up for the fucking blue network.
The blue network.
Support the blue.
Back the blue.
Back the blue.
Mac Weldon Blue Lives Matter.
For every order, $1 goes to Officer Brian Sicknick's family, who was raped to death at the Capitol.
Raped by the insurgents.
This fucking bastard pig, RIP, had a fire extinguisher shoved in his ass.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
All cops are bastards. Especially,
this guy's good, though.
He's the kind of bastard like, you know, Sean Connery would respect him after being his enemy.
Yeah, right. He's a bastard, but he's a hero.
I'm Antifa, but he's a very good guy.
Sean Connery.
Yeah, Sean.
Mumbai Indian. Sean Connery.
Oh, Bombay Sean.
Bombay Sean.
Raj Connery.
Raj Connery.
My name is Bon James Bond, and I want to give a kiss to our Porsche.
My name is Bon James Bond.
Bon James Bond. And I want to go kiss your pussy.
That's awesome, man. Oh, fuck, dude. Sucking a dick because I'm gay.
Putting a dick inside my ass. If you like Cumtown and you're upset with the quality of this episode, you can always go to patreon.com/cumtown and sign up and get an additional... phoned in,
but yeah, the really good ones are there.
No, we save the good
really
ones.
Good ones are
the
there.
Ones, we don't sell out on those.
We
no
actually,
ads.
Those ones are is a writer's room.
Yeah, we plan them out for
they're
a long
scripted.
Time.
We got Asian girls, Indian girls, black girls.
We got whatever the fuck
all
you want.
Types of girls writing our
all
episodes
type, all
on
type
Patreon.com.
It's basically Mambo Number 5.
Yeah,
our writer's room.
Yeah, we got Pamela.
I wonder. It would be funny if I could manage to somehow still have a conversation with anybody at any fucking anybody in the industry to just be like, I got this idea for a show and I think it'd be really good. But basically, it's like it would be like sort of kind of like a man on the street thing, but we like really try to tackle the issue of gentrification and figure out what's going on with that.
Okay.
And then that's it. That's the pitch. Mm-hmm. But it's a comedic look at gentrification.
Right. Oh, that'd be funny.
Because that's what I think a lot of people, they don't even understand.
Dude, I've never heard that discussed.
Yeah.
We should talk about circles. Stuff like, we should talk about
it's
like.
It's crazy how neighborhoods change.
We should do a show about like white privilege, I think.
Do you think the world's ready for that?
I don't think so.
It's very funny too. We all know that.
I think we should do a show about a guy who keeps shitting his pants.
Mm-hmm.
We should.
That would be an awesome guy.
We should do a show about an Indian guy who grew up with doctors as parents.
It would be funny if Comedy Central just now, like in the last month, aired 4 different shows about Joe Biden.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That were all like, President Dumbass and Cartoon Joe.
Yeah, yeah,
the idiot.
Yeah, yeah.
And they just do that with every president.
That would be
they
honorable,
all, they all tank.
I would watch a Joe Biden show, man.
Yeah.
He is so
he's a good character.
If you put a dick in my ass. I would watch that before I watch a Trump show.
Yeah.
That has the opportunity to be actually funny.
Mm-hmm.
Biden is hilarious, dude.
I said, listen, Cole House.
Imagine how mad Hillary Clinton is every day she sees a picture of Joe Biden as president.
Me and Clinton were talking about making a movie. And I said, what kind of movie? He said, take your pants off. I'll show you. I said, I don't know about that. That seems kind of weird. But sometimes you got to do weird things so you can go ahead and do the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
That's you got to right. do stuff that feels weird just so you can help some guy get off.
Damn, Joe Biden and Clint Eastwood having gay sex. That would be awesome, dude.
Joe, why don't you take your pants off? Joe, what the hell are you doing?
I'm sucking your cock.
So you're sucking my cock, huh? Well... good job.
Are you feeling gay?
You gotta ask yourself that question. Where am I? That's not the right question. Where the hell am I?
It's
We're in the master bathroom. We're in a handicapped stall in the Penn Station.
I know a guy that likes to hang out there.
That would be awesome if they got caught having gay sex in a public restroom.
There's that guy.
And he's with Joe Biden. Yeah.
So I walk in there, and there's the president. And
wow, it's my lucky day.
And I said, fellas. Jackpot. You're stealing my bits.
I'll forgive you if you let me suck your cocks.
Oh, we had a friend. We called him Gay Joe. Took it to Gay Joe and come by, and he lived in a bathroom.
The president is having lunch. The president will be getting lunch.
He's having his 3 p.m. dinner.
Now everybody's just can't wait to suck off this Jen Psaki woman.
Who's that?
The press secretary.
They
you
like want
to fuck her? I mean, I would, but I wouldn't be that thrilled.
The redhead lady?
She's the best. She's perfect.
She can suck my little prick as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah.
It's just like, she's just going to lie. Like, everyone's like, oh, it's just so nice to have somebody who doesn't lie to you.
It's so
who
refreshing.
Loves facts. It's like, no, she's don't absolutely lie. Lying.
Yeah,
it's
the
so
point
funny
of the job.
To go back to just concentrating on myself instead of making everything about myself via politics.
Yeah. Oh, man. It's so refreshing to have a woman who says, I will look into that for you, Dale.
The American people should know I accidentally got my dick ripped off in a toaster oven. I thought you could fuck it, and it turns out you can. If you put your penis in a toaster. In a toaster.
I forgot. I can't remember what he sounds like. I mean, it's fucking...
It doesn't matter. That's so, a good approximation.
It's so elusive.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna cruise and pretend.
Does he talk in public anymore? I think they kind of hit him away.
That's why it's hard.
They hit him away.
You never hear him speak.
That was the nice thing about the campaign is he had to, like, contractually
and
speak.
And he wasn't even out there that much.
No, they hit him away.
Yeah, it was debates and, like, one speech every, like, month.
On Zoom.
Yeah.
Little have a star. Tell us where you wonder are. Up above the clouds so high. Joe,
go back to bed.
need,
you're having a stroke.
That'd
again.
Be
doubles.
Cool if we had a deep fake president, though.
Yeah.
I remember a song I used to sing to Bo when he was going to sleep. Little have a star.
How
I wonder how you are. Up above the clouds so high, wonder why it's you and I.
Where's Hunter? Is he getting pussy?
Yeah, he's back getting pussy.
I love that guy.
He's trying to be an artist, too. Fuck which is yeah, sick. Dude.
Trying to do art.
Hunter, you're invited to become on the podcast.
Mm-hmm. Me and my dad, we used to smoke crack together.
We're going to have all the Hunters on.
What if that's just what Hunter Biden sounds like?
He has a little bit of it. It's obviously his dad, but yeah.
Does he?
I don't know what his voice sounds like at all, actually.
Sounds like my cock going into your mouth, huh?
It does sound
that's
like
rude,
that.
That's rude, Mr. President.
It does sound like that, Adam.
That's rude to me.
Sounds like taking a shit.
Sounds like shitting in your own pussy. I'm gay. Suck my dick.
Let's get another tequila on the way
suck
out.
Suck my dick. Nah, let's just fucking end
my
the show.
Penis.
My penis. I'm gay.
Yeah. Suck my penis.
ISIS, get the fuck back inside, you dumb bitch.
And here we are. This is the bonus episode. There'll be another one coming later today. Just a piece of shit from earlier this week.
I think people are going to like the piece
of
shit.
Oh, yeah, it'll be fine, but, you know, you get two today. So
that's a
complain.
Bonus, guys. Hey, mm-hmm. Thank your pal Stav, a man of the people, who wants our shitty episodes out there.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I drove a half hour, at least hear a sort of riff for an hour, you know? That's how
I
feel.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. We got big, big fat nuts Jake in the building.
Yes. Yes. Hello.
Yeah, Adam's gone back to Africa.
Mm-hmm.
Another little trip to Africa. I was laughing about imagining Steve Harvey like doing a very anti-Black Panther joke. He saw a Black Panther and he's like upset about it. And he's like, they come from a country called Wakanda.
What kind of name is that? Why didn't they pick a real black country? How about Zaire? How about Chad? How about Hotlanta?
They come from a country called How You Gonna?
Yeah.
Why you How gonna? You finna?
How come? Yeah. Why come?
Oh, that's man.
Good. What kind of name is that?
I am from
that?
Why come? Why come you do this?
Beat
your kids, Africa. Please beat you.
Well, Africa's ahead of the game because they train their kids to beat themselves. Oh, you know, yeah. To shoot. Mm-hmm. They go straight from beat to shoot.
Yeah. Sometimes they do it nude.
That's right.
What was that guy? That fucking warlord?
Idris Elba.
General Butt Naked? It was Idris Elba. New James Bond.
Everyone's getting bad. They're pissed off that the new James Bond is going to be nude with a bone through his dick. That's shrinking everyone's head.
We heard what you were saying. Right. You wanted more representation. Yeah,
the main villain is just a photographer. The guy's got a camera.
He's got a cigarette lighter.
Trying to give him condoms. Yeah.
What is this cue?
It's a pair of pants, James. My name is Toby.
Like that's not really what you're supposed to say, but okay.
That sounds good, man. Yeah. I'd watch the fuck out of that.
Yeah. You ever do that thing where you're like, I'm gonna watch James Bond movies today, and you watch like 5 minutes of one of them, and you're like, oh, these movies suck.
Yeah, they're corny as shit.
They're all bad.
Yeah.
But there's so many of them that it's like, you know, I can't. You want to sit there and consume 45 movies.
And there are those old conical titties that I love so much. With the big puffy nipples. Yeah. Which
welcome to the cone zone.
I don't know what happened to the world, but that titties aren't like that anymore.
Yeah,
I've seen maybe in my lifetime.
It's, you know, it's just the bras. It's
but like, also, I feel like nipples were puffier. It's probably climate change.
So like the moon or something.
Yeah. No, it was more.
The bras were
cone
shaped, so there was more room for a diversity of nipples inside. Mm.
That's why Al Gore is so angry.
Yeah,
because the fucking cone titties went away.
That's right. Tipper's got the most conical ass.
That's why they call it. That's why her name's Tipper.
She fucks him in the ass with her fucking cone tit.
That's if you want to be successful in politics, you have to have family members with retarded names.
That's true.
But this is my. My name's John. This is my brother Zipperhead. This is Kurt.
You gotta have a Jim Bob.
It's K-U-R-N-T. This is my son with extreme Down syndrome. His eyes are completely sealed. Where am I? Quiet, Kurt. Daddy's trying to become president. I can't see anything.
Sarah Palin's got Trigger, right?
Trig.
What are some other
Trigger?
Doesn't Jimmy Carter
Tag Romney?
Tag, that's right.
What a terrible name.
It's ridiculous.
Tag. Blip. Blap. Boo. These are my Republican children. Blip. Blap. Crap. Down. Blip.
My man Mitt Romney went to a Utah Jazz game.
This is like a toothless.
Yeah.
A toothless guy on a porch just pointing at wasps, naming them.
That's
Jab. Doop. Jab. Ship. Dab.
That's what's in the secret Mormon, like the back just of the scatting. Secret church that women aren't allowed into. That guy's in there. Romney went to a Utah Jazz.
This is my
game.
Son. Romney. GURP. Yep.
So he went to a jazz game, and he was, first of all, he was wearing a jersey over like a suit, like a dress shirt tucked into khakis, but also the jersey he picked. The Utah Jazz, they have so many great players. He picked, there's two white players. Mm-hmm. He picked the one that was, the best one is Joe Ingles, who's Australian. He didn't even pick him because he's an immigrant. He picked fucking John Stockton's son, who they only signed because of nepotism, who has never played at all for
he's
the
never
Jazz.
Played any basketball.
He's literally just, they just signed him at the end of the season. He didn't play at all in the series. He, like, they don't even sell that jersey. Yeah. He had to have the whitest member of the Jazz team custom made. Yeah. He couldn't wear any other jersey.
Always my favorite player. Oh, very much so. I enjoy his
he looks like
there's
Adam.
Something about him. I don't know what it is, but I
such a smart player. Yeah.
The only thing would better would be if his name was Blurp. Blurp Sock.
Yeah.
Hornhole. Oh, yeah, this is my son Hornhole. Oh yeah. No, he was conceived on Nantucket.
Mitt's crazy though. He's like, his dad is from Michigan, right? But they went to they were in Mexico first.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that is the funniest clip of all time.
Have you seen that clip?
No.
Oh, you haven't?
It's from like the 2012. He's like campaigning and he's just taking a picture with all these black people and he's posing with them and then he goes, who let the dogs out?
his racist inner monologue just slipped out.
He's trying to fucking like relate to them.
Yeah, yeah.
Who let the dogs out?
Who let the dogs out?
Dude, that's my favorite shit, man. Like when McCain was like, thank you, Daddy Yankee and shit.
Yeah.
Like try to fucking that's slum it with black so people for a day.
Thank you, Daddy Yankee. Yeah. My favorite part about John McCain is apparently he calls his wife a cunt all the time.
Hell yeah.
That fucking rules.
Listen, you fucking cunt.
He calls people chinks all the time. Yeah. Shit. He's just like, I'm not apologizing for
I mean, honestly, if you've been in that fucking prison that long, I feel like you get a pass.
Listen. Well, he gets a pass for the chink thing, kind of, because he has an explanation for it. But the cunt thing is just like...
Well, they were all female guards.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They were all Chinese female guards in Vietnam.
And they were all his wives. He was married to all of them. Listen, you fucking cunt.
Listen, you cunt chink. I love you so much. I never want to leave this place. I hope they don't rescue me.
He was bad at flying planes, though, right? Like, I know
Trump is right about that.
Trump is actually right that he sucks at flying planes. Yeah. He only got to do it because his dad was like in the Navy or something.
He was always fucking yelling at him.
I like people that don't get captured.
That is such a good burn.
Yeah,
just like you've had such a harder life than me. I have just waltzed into being rich by being racist to black people.
He fucking rules. He rules.
Yeah, he's so funny.
There's nothing better. There's nothing more endearing than unchecked, unapologetic privilege.
It's got to be undeserved.
To a point where it's like when was it Eliza Schlesinger went on that rant and she was like, "I grew up upper middle class and I fucking stayed that way through hard work." That whole rant about how fucking lazy people are.
Dude, they all do that shit.
Yeah.
Every fucking rich bitch with like free rent in the city is just like, you know, I earned this.
Work
you didn't
harder.
Work hard enough.
Yeah.
The best people are people who just fucking own it. I got this roommate. I live with this black guy that's just like a Trump Republican.
Hell yeah.
But he owns like this custom made jacket that's got this like severed Trump head on the back. When he told me he was a Republican, I was like, "What's well then why do you have the jacket?" And he just goes, "Odette, that's for the girls." Just blatantly lies.
Yeah, yeah.
To fuck women in Bushwick, dude.
Yeah.
He's like my hero.
That's a thing you can lie about. You don't really start to get into trouble where you're like, no, I don't have HIV. It's the Charlie Sheen special.
Yeah.
Wait, he's a Republican? Is he poor? Is he rich? What's going
he's
on?
Rich.
A Republican.
Is he Diamond and Silk's
The Republiblast. That's my new podcast, The Republiblast. Where I just do impressions of different black guys that are Republicans. And then see if you get people to listen to it. And then at the end, like, you know, a couple months in, it's like, it turns out it's just one white guy.
Yeah.
It's a friendless white guy.
Yeah.
Like, see, there are black Republicans. Like, oh, no.
I do love that shit.
Same thing as last time.
I love that shit. Someone was like, I saw a fake account called The Dope Conservative.
Yeah, it's always like that in comment sections. It's like, as a black man, I'm always wondering why, like to disrespect the police. I'm black myself, and I think it's disgusting what those people, I mean, we do.
Those Diamond and Silk people just got, like, straight up paid.
Yeah.
And I think they just didn't get, like, give a fuck.
Yeah.
Like, if you just opt out and just stop giving a fuck about politics altogether, pay me enough money, I'll say whatever.
Oh, yeah, that's where we're at.
Fucking
We're a psyop.
Yeah.
We've been paid by the Trump administration.
Yeah, I'm actually a U.S. Army project to see how jacked a podcaster can get.
Yeah. Wouldn't it be so fucking funny if it came out that we literally were like part of the alt-right? Like we're like on someone's payroll to...
Well, you know, so many people probably...
I mean, we literally are on some...
You're
get
right.
Paid by
we're ground funded by them. Yeah, it's grassroots alt-right, actually, if you think about it.
All alt-right stuff is grassroots.
That's true.
Trump was a grassroots president.
Yeah, I guess he literally was.
Yeah, I just want to go back to like just not caring, which I'm already there, I think.
Yeah.
You know, after the Me Too thing, it's like, all right, I'm done.
Why?
I'm done. I've been through enough of these, like, get madam ups that happen online that it's like, yeah, I don't.
What's the next?
I feel like I'm thoroughly just not.
What would have to happen for you to care again?
Another 9/11.
Then you would, like, a tear would well up in your eye and you would suddenly get patriotic or something?
No, I don't think I'd fall victim to that.
It'd be cool if you started getting into, like, country music and shit.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, that's the kind of thing I could do.
Took a weird fucking turn because you got a brain tumor late in life that turned you into a fucking hick.
That would be awesome.
Yeah,
that'd be funny.
You go Dennis Miller. Wasn't Dennis Miller liberal before 9/11?
Yeah, a lot of people were.
It's hilarious.
That's
9/11 broke a lot of people.
Yeah.
Yeah, Hitchens was fucked up by it.
Damn, Hitchens isn't even American.
Yeah, I know.
The fuck does that British piece of shit care?
No, there's a lot of people that just started hating Muslims and they couldn't.
Mm.
It's the Islam thing. Yeah. When you watch Wild Wild Country, there's a clip. It doesn't credit him, but you can hear his voice. Mm. It's him like narrating a video of like one of their weird nude fucking cult freakouts. And he's just like these savages, completely driven insane by the Quran. You know,
yeah.
It's just a bunch of fucking hippies.
Yeah,
yeah. He went crazy. I don't know. Who else?
My dad. I guess he.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he started disliking.
My parents did not give a fuck. They did not like Greek people. Just didn't care at all. Like everyone was like sad for a sec, but they don't fuck. They didn't hate Muslims any more than they did before.
It made me like Muslims. Yeah. I thought it was pretty cool. Mm-hmm. It was like,
they're very resourceful.
Well, I was pretty convinced like that Israel thing. Did it. So, I mean, I didn't really see how Muslims are involved. Clearly the Jews. You know, none of them were in the towers that day.
Oh, yeah, they all called out.
Yeah. All the Jewish
people. I love that one, dude. That's the best one. All the Jews that worked at the World Trade Center took their vacation day that day.
Yeah, they did a flash mob.
Fuck. Damn.
Oh, boy.
You think Trump's going to try and do a 9/11 just fuck it up so bad?
No, but he, there's going to be... North Korea is going to give up its nuclear program. There's like it's a peace treaty. Yeah, it's disarmament. There's going to be a unified Korea, and it's going to be Trump. Trump did it.
That is so funny.
That's the funniest shit ever. It's just breaking people's brains.
Yeah.
I've seen people try to like argue their way out of that. Well, it's like actually, you know, he shouldn't get the credit for it because somebody was like, you know, somebody on Facebook was like, actually, I think the credit should go to Kim Jong-un's sister.
Were they trolling?
No, it was just some fucking idiot, man. Everyone's politics just broke out.
Yes, queen.
Women are incapable of being authoritarian nutjobs, so there's no way that Kim Jong-un's sister is not just like me, a woke American girl. Yeah.
She's empowering women by killing people and feeding them to dogs. Yeah. You know, for other women to rise up,
you know, I don't. Feeding people to dogs in Korea—that's like, that's the balance. You know it's what I mean?
Absolutely. I see where you're going with it. Yeah. I don't. Just the yin and the yang.
Right. Exactly.
It's usually
you eat a certain amount,
people.
You got it.
Exactly. Like if we were feeding people to cows here, I wouldn't have a problem with that.
Absolutely.
That's what we should do. We should round up all the Indian people and feed them to cows. It's what they want.
That is true. That is in the. Hare Krishna book.
The Hare Krishna.
It's in the Hare
Krishna
book.
What is their book? Not the Kama Sutra.
Clifford the Big Brown Dog.
There's one though, right? Not what's the Bhagavad Gita? What the fuck is that?
Bhagavad Gita?
Yeah, what is that?
The Bhagavad Gita.
Bhagavad Gita, baby. It's so stupid.
What's the Inagata Devia? Isn't that the Hindu text? The sacred text?
I don't know.
Hey,
what the
Bhagavad Mom, you got the Bhagavad Gita.
There's different Bhagavads, and they're all like, I think that's what Hinduism is like, you know, those are the like religious texts, I think.
Mm.
Bhagavad Gita is the one that has like that Oppenheimer quote in it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And become death, destroyer of worlds.
That's pretty badass quote, actually.
Yeah. It's like, it's you know, Oppenheimer was like, when we finally make this bomb, I'm going to say that shit. And then, like, 4 months later, they made the bomb, and then he was like,
I've become death, destroyer of worlds. People are like, damn, dude.
He had it in his
put
drafts.
That on a plaque.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
He's like,
dude.
I've got the sickest tweet planned.
I'm going to drop this shit. It's going to go off.
when we kill all those Japanese people.
Yeah. He was a fucking, like, Louis J. Gomez Monster Energy guy. Yeah, yeah.
It was awesome. I'll give it to you.
Fingerless gloves.
Yeah. I always, like, all these people had, like, regret and shame after... You know, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, like everyone involved was like, what the fuck is this? Like, the next war is going to destroy the world. With the exception of Paul Tibbetts, the pilot of the Enola Gay, who would then go around the country doing demonstrations of how he killed the Japanese. He would fly like a replica plane. He'd be like, and that's when I dropped a bomb on all those idiots. Those slant eye motherfuckers. I got them.
Serves you right.
Bum, bum, ba, 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 ba. And imagine going to see that. I don't know what's worse, being Paul Tibbetts or being the guys that are like, do you want to go to the reenactment of the massacre? Like, yeah, they have
innocent
that,
people right, caught up.
They got beer battered ballpark pretzels, I think.
Oh, yeah.
And then afterwards, there's a kite festival.
Mm-hmm. Well, what they serve is mutated fish sticks.
Yeah.
They serve fucking three-eyed. I just watched that Simpsons where
Burns
running for what is it, mayor or some shit, governor? I don't fucking know.
I don't know.
But
ahoy, hoy.
Yes,
I'm gay.
That's good.
Gay, yeah. Mr. Burns.
Smithers,
that's
I'm gay.
Yeah. Me too, sir. What?
Damn, Smithers pounded off to.
Yeah,
Burns a lot.
It was heavily implied that he was jacking off quite
for sure. Yeah, yeah. For sure. That one app. That one app where his screensaver is like.
Hello, Smithers.
Yeah.
You really turned me on.
Like, it's so much weirder that he wanted to fuck Burns than that he was gay. You know what I mean? It's like,
yeah, that makes sense.
You think so?
Yeah,
he has a daddy thing.
Yeah,
he
does. Oh yeah, because Mr. Burns is like a million years old.
But he can't fuck you hard.
I used to do Simpsons trivia. Mr. Burns is 104.
Is that a fact?
Yeah.
How old
so it
now?
Never changed.
I think
right?
He was 106 in one episode, but I think, he's 104.
Yeah, because
I think.
The same
I don't know. I used to just sit online and do Simpsons trivia.
Oh, on the internet?
Yeah, when I was like 11.
Hell yeah, dude. Yeah.
Oh, man.
Did you win anything from it, or was it for the love of the game?
Yeah, it's just. That's,
I had, remember before I knew that you could like look at pornography and yell at people on the internet when I was a kid, I used to go to like. DiscoveryChannel.com.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just actually use it like in the most wholesome ways. Look up ladybug facts and shit.
Fuck, man.
Yeah.
I used to play.
I remember using the like Encyclopedia
Britannica
to like look up the Hindenburg disaster, how thermonuclear weapons work. I was like obsessed with war and like, yeah, it's like massacres and shit.
I loved Middle Ages shit. Like, I love fucking. Yeah. Like, just feudalism and shit like that.
Yeah.
Like, King Arthur. I wanted to know if that shit was real and shit like that. I love that shit, dude.
That shit was cool. It's cool, like, learning independently as a kid. You're like, oh, I can see why they decided to do school, but then they put...
Yeah, then they put you in that fucking dumb gay fucking building.
Yeah,
you gotta learn stupid bullshit.
You should be able to learn on your own.
Yeah.
That's why my child will have an iPad and a mother and no father.
I'm just going to put an iPad.
I'm
going
to send my son a new iPad every month in the mail. Daddy loves you.
I'm not telling you where I live.
I live next door. I just won't come over.
Yeah.
Like, your father's gaming. Your father decided it was more important to play Battlefield than be involved in your life.
Do you guys remember
my son's name, Smithers? So iPad's like, hello, Smithers.
Damn, dude. And then if someone wants to get at you, like get back at you, because of the you'll have so many enemies at that point.
Yeah,
they could do that movie Old Boy, but it's your son fucks you.
Yeah,
you look like Mr. Burns, and then he fucks you.
Yeah, I don't think I have that many enemies. I guess Tom Myers is now an enemy. It's weird because I was able to like. Trick Tom, and I had the same relationship with Tom that everyone else does, which is Tom, great set, you know, like which is all anybody does to Tom Myers, and then something, I guess, like when I showed everybody that Ed Schrader
video.
I'm but like, we've been talking about that for a year. People knew about that.
Yeah, I don't know why Tom has it out for. I've never said anything bad about him other than just like point at him and be like, you have to see this.
Yeah. Well, we've definitely said bad things about him.
Of course. Yeah, but it's like, so has everybody.
Yeah. You know? Well, but I think it's literally when people started tweeting at him that he realized, like, because he doesn't understand that people are basically making fun of him, everyone who interacts with him. But because people would tweet at him, and it took, I guess that's what the sheer
also,
volume.
If you're listening to this, don't be mean to Tom.
Yeah.
Like, just appreciate him for being. Tom's not an asshole. Tom's just an insane person.
Yeah.
There's no reason
to
be
soul.
Abusive towards him.
It's like going to the zoo and throwing rocks at a kangaroo.
Well, it's like Chris Chan. It's like some people take it too far.
He's like Harambe.
With Chris Chan, it's like Chris Chan's just like a retarded man. Yeah. And he does enough on his own that you can laugh at. You don't have to, like, you know, like threaten him or scare him. Yeah, there's no reason to do that. Just appreciate him. I don't know if you saw the other day, but Chris Chan tweeted. I have to pull up the tweet because I want to make sure I get the wording exactly right. But, you know, he always needs money because he's got these ongoing lawsuits with GameStop.
Oh, no. So what was Chris Chan willing to do for money?
Did I show you the tweet?
Yeah.
It's so funny. And then he gets people send him money, you know, and it's presumably to keep the lights on at his house. And then he just, like, the lights still get shut off. And then he's just posting pictures with, like, new Legos.
Playing Wii on, like, a generator.
Yeah. He tweeted, everyone, pull yourselves together, and if y'all want to see another house tour video, $200 directly to my PayPal gets y'all the house tour, inside and outside. No negotiations on the price.
Okay.
And
so he wants people.
He did a house tour for free, and that's when people saw how fucked up the house he was living in is.
Right.
And then I think like the Department of Health got involved, and then this is part of a tweet thread. The next tweet is, anyone living locally to me in Virginia or visiting Charlottesville, I'll give y'all BJs for money too.
Jesus Christ.
Serious. This is serious.
Yo, you know there's one like completely brain broken motherfucker that was like, dude, I'm about to get blown from Chris Chan as a bit.
He's going to get stung by the cops because of that fucking sex trafficking law.
Yeah, dude.
I'll give y'all BJs for money.
Y'all want some beat? The word y'all is
this is like a down home BJ, dude.
Yeah, right.
It's like very casual.
It comes with fixins. Yeah.
Beat off into this biscuit.
Why don't you slather my cock up in some cream chip beef? Suck it off with some little smokies.
Yeah. I was going to cook up a mess of BJs.
Why don't you suck this hollandaise sauce out of my asshole? we're just reckoning to do some BJing this morning. Yeah, for delicious breakfast time, classic meal. Hog and eggs.
Salute. Can you just say you're going to suck people off for money on the internet?
Yeah, if you're retarded.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, that's the loophole, the legal loophole. Yeah. Technically, if you're retarded, he got us again.
Just imagine being part of working at the district attorney's office that has to deal with Chris Chan and the numerous charges against him for assaulting GameStop employees. And you're like, you're going to work, it's like 8 a.m., you make good money, but it's still like, you need to like pull that big file and put it on your desk, just read about this autistic man that's macing GameStop employees and offering to suck people's dicks on the internet
because
for Lego
the Sonic
money.
Cardboard cutout is a different color of blue than he likes. That's not the official blue.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if he does a mass shooting. That's probably the next step.
You think he's got it in him?
Virginia's got real lax gun laws. That's I would not be surprised.
You can buy a gun technically if you're retarded.
And you know, if Chris Chan did a mass shooting where a bunch of people died and it was him, you know, if he got like 70 people, he broke the record.
Damn,
or whatever.
No way.
If that happened.
Yeah.
It like, we would all just be like, and that's the show. You know?
That's
nothing,
all, folks.
There'd be nothing else that could ever top that in terms of like events. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
That would be just the great. The,
yeah, like Jake Tapper reading about, like yeah. going into the background of him.
They would have to spend years.
Manifesto. They would, right, exactly. They Sonic would, and GameStop right, and shit.
Well, when he lost the competition for the best Parappa the Rappa impression to Liquid Chris, that's when it became clear that Chris was not headed in the right. Sorry, Christine. I don't know if we should misgender her.
Oh, shit. Is it Christine?
Yeah, it's Christine. Though. I love that. I mean, just it's so funny. His journey here is because it all started. I mean, people, he had the comics, but people didn't really know who he was online until he published that video. They're like, it's wrong to be gay, you know, standing in front of his house. So it's like this homophobic retard.
Y'all want some blowjobs?
Yeah, yeah. I'll give you all BJs. Yeah. I mean, it's like the fact that he wound up, I mean, when he became trans initially, it was like, what the fuck is going on in his backyard, digging up his dead dog, tucking his penis through his legs, going, saying, would you fuck me? I'd fuck me. And it's like, well, I guess this can't get any crazier. He's like in jail and an online Lego prostitute. I go, all right.
Salute to a real one, Christine Chen.
Yeah.
A beautiful woman.
Nah, he's got to break Stephen Paddock's record. He's going to team up with that Chinese woman that assisted Paddock.
Oh, nice.
Avoided all charges.
Nah, she doesn't have it in her, dude.
Yeah.
You know? Beautiful Chan. She's a lover, dude, not a fighter.
Marlene, what was her name?
I don't know.
Marianne. Remember Marianne Stephen Paddock's
Wong?
Girlfriend?
No.
The Chinese woman.
Oh, yeah.
She bought him a bunch of jade and other rare Chinese elements.
Brought you
him.
Jade from the Far East.
Yeah, yeah.
Many
and
oils.
A secret talisman. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, you got me jade.
there's a mummy trapped inside of this.
Did you see how Trump said he was talking about the special or the Paralympics, and he was like, I watch some, but not too much. It's kind of hard to watch, you know?
Yeah. That's the thing. It's like
he's so fucking funny, man.
He's
whoa.
The thing about him is he's like he's just honest. And that's what people don't like about him. Is he says shit that people just can't stand.
The saying it's hard to watch though. It's like like not being like it's not good or it's like kind of boring. You said it's hard to watch.
Yeah, they're not very good at the sports, you know. Yeah. I mean, who wants to watch that, you know? Yeah. Some guy can't
slam dunk.
The
form is all sloppy. The shot put guy forgot it was a shot put, thought it was a giant chocolate chip and started trying to eat it.
How about shit put? You just launch a turd out of your ass across the field.
Oh, straight out of your ass.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. They just drop on the ground because it's physically impossible. It's just people just bending over, just shitting as hard as possible. The turds just still drop out of their ass in between their legs.
Like,
and here we have Marcus Dietrich from Germany. It's the record holder, 2.5 inches.
An all Schnitzel diet is how he.
And he's. And he scored a zero.
It would be interesting if society rewarded that to see how far we could shoot shit out of our asses.
Desmond Feverberg from South Africa. He's an interesting competitor. He's only 22 years old, but he's been shitting since he was an infant. And let's see what he can do for us here. And he scored a zero.
Nah, dude, I guarantee you some shits I've taken.
No one scores anything. They just stand in a circle.
Russian guy with like steroids and shit.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Dmitry Vladishenkov is next from Russia. And his father actually invented the sport as a way to keep his family warm before they were executed. And he scored a zero.
No, dude, you've never had a shit rocket out of your ass before?
Nope, never.
Jake?
Yeah.
Come on.
It's real, dude.
It's real. Here's how you would have to train.
Damn.
You'd have to eat a gassy food.
I guess that's what coming is like for women.
Yeah. Yep, yeah. It's like shit rocketing out of your pussy. Mm-hmm. You'd have
Didn't
to
be funny, like the guy who's like a cuck and like he's like, his wife's giving birth, and it's obviously someone else's kid, but the kid just like slides out immediately. He's just never in labor. He's like, oh, yeah, I guess that's what's how it's supposed to happen. His wife's so loose. She's like, oh, my God. Oh, he's here.
The kid walks out upright.
Yeah.
But I think, to go back to my shitting theory, which I think, you know, we should spend some time on, I think you would have to hold in a shit for a while. Is that ever happened to you where you're holding in a shit and you let out little air farts, just a little, letting the air out over a couple hours, let's say, and then finally, when you get back home, it's like there's like a shit disc blocking your tract, and then it just like, you just really fart loud as hell, and it just like really rockets out of your ass.
It's like a potato cannon.
Yes, exactly. It builds up pressure. Yes. Thank you, Jake. Jake knows what I'm talking about, Nick. You've never experienced this?
No.
That happens when I drink like 19 Miller High Lifes.
Yeah, it's usually shit. It's usually beer shits or like...
Oh, you know what? Yeah, I do know what you're talking about.
Yeah, thank you, man. I appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. It's real.
So those guys could probably score pretty good.
Real, Scully.
Yeah, these guys drink Miller Lite all night.
Yeah, the diet would be very important in this sport.
Man, I was thinking about drinking again.
said this like... Yeah, Nick, ruin your life.
We'll see what the heart doctor says. I gotta go tomorrow.
If I had to guess, the heart doctor would be like, "Yeah, relapse. That'll help your heart." Yeah.
No, I mean, if it's
prescribing
like,
you 16 Pabst Blue Ribbons, and Crown Fried Chicken as a supplement.
Yeah, I mean, I think that might happen. You don't know.
You're right. Technically, I do not know. I will give you that.
No, you were a fun drunk, but you were a fucking maniac.
Yeah,
kept getting into like fights with angry mobs.
Yeah,
and
I don't
want
to have to fight people, dude.
Yeah, well, I don't know. I mean, I won't start drinking again. Yeah. I'm not drinking again, no more. But fuck, I have nothing now.
Yeah,
that's I gotta get on this heart. I want this fucking heart medicine so I can just start drinking coffee again.
You miss coffee, huh?
Yeah, I just fucking want a cup of goddamn coffee.
You've had no Joe?
I've had no caffeine at all, and it's like had a nominal effect. I mean, it's like, you know, my blood pressure is down, but it's still high.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's happening with your ticker, man?
It's like I have like insanely high blood pressure.
He's got the
podcasting too much?
No, I don't know.
The medical term is gay bitch ass little heart.
Yes.
Gay coward's little bitch ass heart.
I'm doing
because severe gay bitch ass coward's heart. Type 2.
I'm doing a documentary where I go around the country eating at every Wahlburgers until my heart explodes. It's called Heart of Markness.
Yes. That's fucking awesome, dude.
We're out here doing steroids. Yeah.
Yeah,
doing steroids for retarded kids out here in Boston, at the Boston Plaza.
Dude, that would be, if the doctor's like, you have 6 months to live, that's how you need to spend it, dude.
Yeah.
Trying to get Mark to notice you, dude.
Yeah. I hope that's not what it is. I mean, I'm sure it's not.
It's not. You're going to be fine.
I just got to get on blood pressure medication. I don't know.
What's a
beta blockers or something? They keep Adam at a distance.
Yeah, I was going to say, we can't do the podcast.
Maybe the
then.
Problem is just having to be around Adam. I'm allergic to his fucking bullshit.
Yeah. That would be so, dude. Check your blood pressure now. It's like just zero. It's just so fine.
I made something out of my Moji Mudu cookbook the other day. I was cooking dinner for my wife. My wife. It's cute that I call her that. From my Muji Mumu cookbook. Fucking bitch.
Adam is gay. That is true.
Cook dinner for a woman. Let them eat cum. You know what I'm saying? Give her the old Marie Antoinette. Marie Antoinette.
Oh, yes. Let them eat cum. Marie Antoinette.
Yeah.
There we go,
yeah,
baby.
I'm trying to Queen of France, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Let that bitch eat nut.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Marie.
Yeah. I'm cutting her head off with a guillotine.
I'm trying to meet some guillotines, you know what I'm saying? 14, 15 years old. Yeah, you could say I'm gay for tweens. I'm gay. I'm gay?
I'm gay.
Excuse me, but I'm gay.
I'm gay for tweens.
I'm gay. Thank you.
thanks.
Do you have any? Is this a Jamba Juice? Oh, it is. Okay, well, I'm gay. So, do you have any juices for geese?
We should do
we should do a Queer Eye, but we pretend to be gay, and it's so obvious and offensive, and we just have no good advice.
Yeah. Damn, dude, I love sucking cock and putting up shelves.
We're fucking.
I'm so fucking gay.
Yeah, it's like, what if they call Queer Eye this gay house? Bob Vila.
He's building a glory.
Being
ball.
Held down.
Yeah. He's just putting holes in every wall.
It's the same show, but there's a glory hole everywhere.
Yeah, this is a very nice feature. I
every
like
once in a while, some guy puts his cock through, but he's still just talking about building shit. Yeah.
John, come this over here. Why don't you go ahead and show him how it works?
Yeah.
This is beautiful feature on the pine. You can see they put the hole where the knot used to be. And it accommodates all different sizes of cocks, but it still allows a limited amount of clearance so you can't identify who's on the other side of the wall based on the balls, which is a very important feature in glory hole. You know, and this is, look at this trim here. This is ornate molding taken directly from an armoire we got. It was part of a collection of 1700s pieces by the world's first gay man. A lot of people don't know that, but it was invented in England by the same Bernard Suquois.
That's where the glory
a French
comes
noble.
From.
Yeah. Well, he was a Frenchman. He came over from Calais, and he was living. He was living in London, and he was woodworking and sucking cock.
Oh, so the first gay guy was also a gay carpenter.
Yeah, well, it's still this.
Jesus
it's still
was a gay carpenter.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, that's true.
Created that the is the first gay
guy. He
was
black. He was gay. He was a carpenter. He's retarded.
He had Down syndrome.
Yeah. Immaculate cruelty.
Yeah, people were like, this man is getting drunk off water. He's like, oh, well, whoa, where am I? They're like, this is a miracle.
Yeah,
like he brought that bird back to life. Like, no, he just let go of it. He's suffocating that bird. Yeah. It's like, Joseph's like, that's not my fucking kid. I don't know what happened here, but that's not looks Chinese.
Hell yeah, dude. Mary secretly fucked a retarded guy one night. Said it was an angel.
Well, it's like that song, What If God Was One Of Us, Just a Stranger on the Bus? It's like, who rides the bus? You know?
So true.
They love riding the bus.
Yeah, they do.
Mm-hmm. Another
they
day,
love
another
public
dollar.
They do. On purpose.
Yeah.
It's a hobby.
Mm-hmm.
Elevators.
Yeah.
We all know the stuff they love.
Yeah, there used to be this retarded guy that would ride the bus. This big, he looked like exactly like Mike Lawrence.
Hell yeah, he sure wasn't Mike Lawrence. Yeah. Was he talking about comic books?
These big glasses, and you would always see him on the bus. He just had this deranged look in his face with these big, stupid glasses looking like Mike Lawrence. And my friend James sat next to him one time, and he just looks at him and goes, excuse me! Like made James get
just
up.
For sitting next to
just
him.
Just for sitting next to him. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You retarded well kids up. At your school growing up?
Yeah.
I had tons of retarded kids.
Yeah. Nice.
You grew up in Texas?
Yeah.
Nice.
Mm. There's this guy who would scream whenever I sneezed.
Oh, that's, and they're all on death row now.
Yeah.
There's this guy that
the
like
special
Harry
ed
Potter.
To prison
there
was, pipeline there was a, in Texas.
There's a retarded kid named Jose. I was so mean to him. When I was a little kid. I feel
his
bad
name
about
was Jose.
Him. His name was Jose. He was a retarded kid named Jose. And he was obsessed with Thomas the Tank Engine. And you would
Salute.
Say to him, you would go to him, you go, no way, Jose. And he'd go, no.
Oh,
and
no.
Crying. Yeah, you'd say no
I mean,
way.
How do you not do that
I
as
know.
A little
yeah.
kid?
I just
yeah,
could not
fuck.
Resist saying no way, Jose, to that retarded kid. Like, what do you mean, no way? Yeah.
There was this kid named
you could also Trent. You could also go up to him and be like, Jose, boo, and he would get really scared.
Oh my god.
They all had triggers.
There was this kid named Trenton that was kind of he was retarded and he was kind of hood. Like he kind of dressed
hell
like
yeah.
Fubu and shit.
Hell yes.
And he would be smoking blunts like under a bridge right near where I grew
up.
And
fucked
would,
up by us.
He'd, yeah. he'd roll
fetal
up.
Alcohol syndrome. us by us.
Fasubu.
Yeah. he yeah, man, fucking... this shit fast. I got my fast Subu sweatpants. Fetal alcohol syndrome, us buying. Oh, that's stupid.
Yeah, the fat Albert shirt. And yeah. Shit. He would pass him the
gay,
blunt.
Gay, gay. I'm gay, Albert.
That's a fuck
yeah.
Gay.
Yeah, gay, Albert.
Bum, 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 bum.
Oh, that was Cosby.
Oh, yeah.
That's weird.
Free Bill. Cosby. Another, hey, can you believe it, guys? Another black man railroaded by the criminal justice system.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
Mm-hmm. Let's just pour one out for
him. I still don't.
You go to a Black Lives Matter rally with yeah. a fucking Cosby sign. Like, Bill Cosby, Michael Brown, Eric Garner, and Bill Cosby too.
Just yeah. sneaking them in yeah, yeah. every like seven guys.
OJ also.
Yeah. yeah. Good thing he is going to go to jail. Though. That's pretty fucking. Anyway, what's going on?
I don't understand the point of putting a 97-year-old man in prison.
Let him fucking die in jail. He raped like 50 people that we know. Of.
Yeah, I know, but it's like,
yeah, fuck him. He should have to.
Sure, it's not a question, but it's like, what? It's such a. It doesn't do. Like, he's just gonna be in jail for 6 months.
Yeah, yeah. Why
he's
not?
He's gonna die soon.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, because why would he live? It sucks. Mm-hmm. He's got to be in jail and shit.
Yeah,
I mean, he's got a comfy ass life.
You ever
now.
See how they spell jail in Australia?
Oh.
It's like G-A-O-L.
What?
Yeah. Jail.
Yeah, jail. It's like the medieval spelling.
Whoa, that's fucked up.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
When did people start going to Australia? When did they start sending criminals over there?
1970s.
Really?
Yeah, Jim Jefferies was the first. He founded it.
What was it, like the 1800s maybe? You know the Pope was like fucking... I listened to some shit on Fresh Air, because I fuck with my girl Terry Gross, uh-huh. and they just did a thing about the Pope... like how much like Italy wasn't even a fucking country until like the late 1800s and the Pope had like power over Italy in like the mid 1800s
yeah.
and he was like fucking he had an army and shit and he like he there was Jewish ghettos that the Pope put Jews in. It was fucking wild, dude, in the 1800s. I thought that was like some 1400 shit.
Yeah,
the Pope was powerful as hell until then.
History
the Pope
weird,
is still
dude.
Powerful, dude.
Not really.
Yeah,
yeah, it is. He can really? Move shit with his mind.
If the Pope
yeah.
wants you,
he can molest children with his mind.
If the Pope wants you killed, God. You're gonna die, dude.
What, are you serious?
Yeah, the Pope has people killed.
Should I take that back? What I just said?
You should, dude. You can criticize the Pope on
fuck.
My show.
But the new Pope's cool. Sorry, man.
How dare you, dude? You know this is a Catholic show.
Which actually kind of makes sense why people were so anti-Catholic. Like, I didn't realize the Pope actually had power that late in history.
Yeah.
Like when I heard, like when people were like anti-JFK because he was Catholic.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, yeah, I mean, 70 years ago, the Pope had like an army and shit. I kind of get what where they were coming
from. It's weird
from.
That there's just this yeah. like game.
Well, he
of
still
Thrones
has those clowns. He has those clown swordsmen.
Yeah, those are pretty cool swordsmen. Yeah,
the Pope's army.
He used to live in like a big ass palace in Rome. Do you know that shit?
The Papal Vatican, guards.
The Vatican was like just some shit he had to flee to when Italy, a bunch of wops took over Italy.
Are you going down like a podcast wormhole right now and learning a bunch of shit?
Yeah. No, well, I was on a long ass drive.
This
is,
I recognize mean, that's still, like, this. The funniest. Oh, that's badass.
Yeah, this the Swiss see. Guards. That's the Pope's army. That's how they dress.
Those weird fucking horse hats.
Hell yeah, dude.
Yeah.
Well, what happened, Jake, was that I was on a long drive. I was on the road and I ran out of all the sports podcasts and the Bodega Boys.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I was like, all right, I'll fucking learn some shit, I guess.
No, I know exactly what's going on in your head because I work as a fucking bike messenger and I'll listen to like some dumb like hardcore history or some shit.
Yeah,
and then
like
it's all loaded up in your brain. The next conversation you have is you know, someone's right, like, did you watch
you're listening to Dan Carlin's Toddcore History.
Jesus, actually, Matani. Yeah. That's where Nick just listened to that one.
Dan Carlin.
Dan Carlin here with Toddcore History.
Yeah, shouts out to Terry, though. That's my girl.
Yeah.
I love Fresh Air.
Yeah.
Because it's informative, but not like you don't have to really think that hard. It's well, she knows what the fuck she's doing. You know what I'm saying?
More like
hardcore history.
Terry Gross pussy.
I think we literally made that joke 3 weeks ago.
Probably every day of her life.
Hey, Harry Gross pussy.
Oh, yeah. Harry Gross pussy.
She's just at home, like ripping all of her pubes out with duct tape because her mom won't let her get a pussy razor.
Not until you're older, Terry.
But mom, everyone makes fun of my hairy pussy at school.
Well, then stop showing it to them then.
No! No, I won't. Everyone has to see my pussy. That's her story.
Really? I didn't know that. See, she always interviews
stay tuned
other people.
For another episode of Talk All History. The moon landing.
A lot of people don't know this, but the moon is a circle, and not a square, as commonly thought.
There was a girl we grew up with who was a touch special. I don't know if she was full blown, whatever. Mm-hmm. But she was like trying to make conversation, and she was like, "Who are you guys talking about? Are you guys talking about Mike? Does he have brown hair? Oh, he was." And she was like saying facts that she knew just to like fill up the conversation. She was like, "He has brown hair. Was his cousin Jim? Was he 16 before he was 17?" And then I was like, "Yes." Like that's, as if that's like a trait that only some people have.
Damn, that bitch travels time.
Oh, fuck. Maybe she's a time traveler.
Did you fuck with the show Ghost Rider as a kid? Did you like that show?
Ghost Rider. Yes, yeah, yeah.
I loved that show.
I liked it, but I didn't understand it. It fucked my head up.
What do you mean you didn't understand
it? I watched it a lot, and I didn't retain much of it.
It was really heavy.
It was like a ghost, right?
It's so straightforward. It's four kids that are friends with a ghost.
I just don't remember what happened in it, you know? So I chalked that up to not understanding it as a kid.
I used to watch Barney, but I couldn't put it together. It was like, what is this? This is like Lost. Gotta go online and fucking
the diagrams.
Yeah, it's like a David Lynch endeavor.
No, there's like a Ghost Rider. I think it was a two-parter episode where they go back to the 30s.
Whoa. Yeah. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, because then the ghost is dead and there's like something about time passing.
Wait,
was the ghost was still dead? Well, the 30s?
No, I don't know if Ghost Rider was the ghost that they were remembering, but like something, I don't know.
Oh, they found an older ghost.
Yeah, I don't know if there's...
Look who doesn't fucking get it now, dude.
It's not that I don't
look
get
who
it.
Doesn't understand I, that's Ghost not Rider. How
I don't remember the plot of the episode.
Yeah.
It's the thing I saw
30 years ago.
Tables have turned.
You don't understand tables or how they turn?
I actually don't necessarily understand that expression.
That expression is like when someone like you literally rotates a table to eat their guest's food after they've eaten their own dinner.
That sounds pretty good.
You eat all your food and the other person just barely started and you rotate the table and you go, "Well, look how the tables have turned." And then you just start shoving sausage links in your mouth.
I'm having a mechanical table installed now. Just for that. I press a button.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like for a disabled person. Yeah. Like one of those chairs that goes up the stairs.
Just like a cake mama, like cake assembly table.
Oh, fuck.
Those were the best. Was that like a Mario Party minigame where you had to assemble the the burgers or whatever?
Yeah, that game rules, man.
Dude, Mario Party is the best.
Especially for getting fucked up to the point where you're like retarded enough to enjoy a game that's for like idiots and children.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They basically it was like one night in Austin, we were playing Mario Party, and then I just woke up in a backyard somewhere. Yeah. I was at my apartment.
Did I win?
Yeah.
I was Wario, right?
You went down a tunnel, dude.
I saw Chris the next day. I was like, "What happened?" He's like, "Oh, yeah, you pulled your pants down and ran away."
Yeah, dude. Remember that time you just walked in the door and everyone's like, "Where have you been?" You just went angry mob and then walked to your fucking room.
Yeah, I got beat up outside.
Beat up and making fun of Sugar Ray.
Oh, that was a Sugar Ray night?
No, this is a different night.
Yeah, man. God,
yeah, I had like scrapes all over my head.
Let's move back to Austin and fight everyone.
Yeah. It does seem like a fun place.
It is a fun place.
Yeah, it's a dumb place.
It's a fun place when you're like, because I mean, if you spend too much time in Austin, you turn into Blake. Right. But Blake kind of moved to Austin already as one of those guys.
Yeah, right.
Like, you can't, that shit you up can't here. Keep living like a fucking 21-year-old for the rest of your life. I mean, I'm sure it's nice, but then you get into your mid-40s and you're just like some Austin bar guy that's like,
right.
Yeah, we're going to go float the river again. You know, and it's like, is that living? Yeah. I don't know.
Well, you can do all that shit. I just don't understand
how
you do
it. No, move to New York and become a fucking cocaine millionaire. Yeah. This is a much better life than being some fucking Texas burnout.
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm saying. I was like, people do that, but like, I don't understand how they don't have this huge existential hole, you know?
Yeah.
They're just like, maybe. I'm going to be 50 and fucking working at the Alamo Draft House or something. Right, yeah. You know?
Exactly.
Maybe they're just content with themselves, you know? Maybe they didn't have abusive or shitty childhoods, and they're like, yeah, I'm a fucking idiot.
No, those people are depressed, dude.
Yeah,
you're probably
right. Yeah, especially the ones that move to Austin to do something.
Yeah, that's true, because you're right. No one just moves to Austin just to fucking
if you
do
wanted
that.
To be like a musician or some shit, and you know, now you're just a fucking bartender, and you work on E6, and you're like part of that E6 crew, and
yeah,
you know.
Hell yeah.
What do they do? Just they all just like eventually date each other.
Yeah.
And they're like, yeah, me and Jamie are actually dating now. It's like, oh, I guess, yeah, you guys have fucked everyone else you know.
It is weird. It becomes like a high school. Because if you like, there's like groups in like high school or growing up where everyone just takes turns fucking dating. And yeah. it just becomes camp for adults.
Yeah.
Which actually does sound kind of nice, you know?
Yeah. I mean, that is what Austin is. It's a fucking daycare center for alcoholics.
Hell yeah.
So what's the problem with it?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, I'm like going to try to do some shit here in New York, probably kill myself in like 5 years or possibly just completely move, you know, move to like a place like that and just like,
I don't know. I mean, I don't know.
It's a good place
New
to
York's,
die.
New York's been very good to me. So I can't imagine ever wanting to leave New York, but if like things had gone different, I mean,
I'm just fucking around.
Yeah.
That's like an exit plan for life.
Yeah.
You know, if I was like, give up on everything, I'd move there like New Orleans or something.
I mean, New Orleans is a place to do
New
that
Orleans,
shit.
Yeah. I mean, I got very lucky, but I don't know myself well enough to know like if I had moved to New York and like just wound up as like a Brooklyn dog walker, you know, doing the fucking, you do mics and you get your like two or three spots a month at like a real club, if that, and then you just continue doing this to no end. I don't, because I mean, I've been doing comedy 13 years and like I have things going on, but it's still like, I don't want to fucking do this shit anymore.
Yeah.
I still have that feeling.
It's dumb as hell.
Yeah. Yeah.
What I would do is just sell boy pussy online.
What I'm saying is, I could possibly see myself moving back to Austin if I was like in a desperate situation here.
I would,
but then I would get there and immediately be depressed that I had like.
You
failed
should move overseas.
That'd be the worst day of your fucking life.
Yeah,
just moving back into the sandstone apartments.
Yeah, moving back into sandstone and being a sandstone guy again.
Yeah,
that's the thing. That's like how I knew New York was going well. Is I would go back to Austin and it did nothing for me. I did Moon Tower like 2 years ago. And it was like almost like a burden to be in Austin.
Yeah.
It's fucking boring. You know, there's nothing I care for there anymore.
Yeah. No, the exit strategy friends, is obviously, Thailand. Go to Thailand or something.
For me, actually, yes. That's serious. That's what I would do. Yeah.
I would go overseas. Live in China.
I would live
shit.
In some fucked
Japan.
Up place. Yeah, way far away. I could
go native.
Like the end of Silence of the Lambs. Just disappear in some fucking.
I'm having an old
place.
Friend for dinner. And then it's like Chris Chan getting off a plane. I'm like rubbing my dick. Get my dick hard. Goodbye, Clarice. I'm here for the BJs.
Is that what happens in Silence of the Lambs? He leaves?
Yeah, well, he eats Anthony Heald.
Who's Anthony Heald?
The doctor from the...
He eats Andy Heald.
I haven't seen the movie.
You haven't seen something?
No, I have not.
It's first of all, it's probably the best
it's
like
not
thriller.
About Greek food.
It's probably the best thriller. I know people are going to have a problem with me saying that, but
I can rewatch
Silence of the Lambs like probably every single fucking day. That is like, it's like the perfect thriller.
Nice. He's not in that long, right? Or some shit?
Who?
Anthony Hopkins?
No, he's in the entire movie.
I thought he's in it for like 20 minutes or something.
His face
shit.
Is on the cover of the movie.
I know, but I thought I thought he like...
This film, are there lambs?
I thought that's what was so good about his acting, was that he was barely lambs? In it and he was that good. Are there lambs?
I mean, maybe he's
like a
not,
hero?
Maybe he's not like... I mean, he's not in it as much as fucking... what's her name? Starling or... What's the...
Jodie Foster,
yeah. But I mean, he's definitely like... That's in as a supporting role, like prominently featured in the movie.
Yeah.
To say that Anthony Hopkins is barely in Silence,
that he's not in it that much for someone starring in a movie is my point.
He's
I
not
think.
A supporting cast.
All right, well that's
yeah, he's in it. He's in it probably as much as Ken Levine or what's his
Buffalo
name?
Buffalo Bill.
Yeah, Buffalo Bill.
Nice.
You don't know what pain is. That's such a great line.
Maybe I'll watch it.
Yeah,
yeah.
I love that movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hear good things, man.
Yeah.
I hear good things about Silence of the Lambs.
You should check it out. You should check it out for sure.
Yeah, dude.
What else the fuck happened? Oh, did you guys see Michelle Wolf?
No.
Yeah.
The Correspondent? It was awesome.
Yeah, it was the only time I've ever really liked the Correspondent.
She racked them up, dude.
Yeah,
she did great.
It was good.
Anyways.
Dennis Miller actually tweeted like, I don't know. This woman is vile. I don't know much about her. I'm going to do some research and have some very mean jokes about her. And it's like, damn, Dennis Miller's going to get his ass eaten, dude.
Yeah.
Like, Dennis Miller has not even been paying it. It's just going to be great.
I'm going to pay Chris Chan to suck the president's dick. London.
And that's
Olympus.
How North Korea.
Yeah. Olympus is nutted.
Oh, maybe that's what it was.
Mr. President, you're going to want to see this. It's a video of you getting your dick sucked by Chris Chan. What if that's what they had instead of the P tape? It's a video of Trump getting his dick sucked by Chris Chan for Lego money.
Oh, fuck, dude.
That's got to be the worst blowjob in the world, too.
Maybe.
Imagine how fucking bad he is at sucking dick.
Maybe she's good at sucking dick.
No, he's
got, like,
no way.
Hair on his pubes.
No way is fucking Chris Chan good at sucking
you're
cock.
Right. You're right.
It's got to be the word, like the toothiest, like
truly a very ugly.
Not understanding
person.
That it's supposed to be like an up and down motion, just like a side to side action going on.
But
blah blah blah. He's never had sex. He doesn't know how it works. You've seen the video of him. My favorite Chris Chan video, is the one where. So he's had this series of like
a picture.
The reason he's gay is because of these 13-year-old boys that have like girl voices, like call him up on the phone and pretend to be women to like trick him into humiliating himself.
God damn it! What a, what a horrible life. Like on both sides.
I know.
You're making a grown man horny. Yeah, a grown retarded man is beating off to you and you're a child.
I love this world, dude. That's the kind of shit that makes me feel okay, you know?
That is a real problem,
there's
Nick.
There's a place for people like me in this world.
It's the worst
online.
Part of the world.
Anyways, so these kids call him up, and he had this one. He was this girl Ivy that he was thought he was dating on the internet.
Oh,
and
God.
So he makes this video in his bathroom, and he's completely nude. And he goes, Ivy, may I have this dance? And then he's pretending to dance.
Oh,
there's no one there. So he's just slow dancing. But he walks into the frame and his like just disgusting ass, you know, as he goes towards the shower stall. And he gets in the shower stall and his like tiny fucked up dick or whatever. And his like stupid body. And the bathroom is disgusting. There's just like grime everywhere. And it looks like Resident Evil. You know?
Dude, a chill just went down my spine.
And so he's like pretending to dance. And then he goes to spin the imaginary girl and loses his balance.
No. No. Yeah. And he posted it?
Yeah, he posted it. Let me see if I can find the video. Oh, my God, dude. It's
That does sound really funny and horrific at the same time.
Drops the invisible woman.
I'm so glad I didn't have access to the internet until like 7 years ago.
Yeah, dude, kids today are fucked.
Yeah, I mean, Nick is fucked. Like, even, like, people, all my friends that were, like, early internet bros, there's a part of them that's, like, a little too fucked up, I think. Were you a big internet guy, Jake?
I don't know if I was as heavy into the, like, the weird, like.
When did you get internet as a kid?
I was, like, 13 or something like that.
A video of him eating his own cum.
No, man.
Yeah. He puts it up to the cum, because he was, for a while, he was eating his own cum. Yeah.
That's the for us, by us. You know?
Yeah. Oh, fuck, dude, no.
Yeah, that's a real fast Subu.
It's true for Subu. Jesus Christ.
Anyways, yeah. He was eating his own cum for a while because he thought it, like, I don't know. He's like, you're not supposed
mystical
to nut
properties.
Or something. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, it's like, great.
They got a transcript. He's in his green bathrobe. This is for my sweetest Ivy's only. Ivy's eyes only. Chris holds up a small disposable cup made of clear plastic. A thick white liquid rests in a thin layer along the bottom. Here's some of my cum. I just masterboarded out. He says things wrong.
Okay.
He points at his own semen in the cup and brings it even closer to the camera.
Dude.
About to that much. That's usually a lot. Chris holds a can of Fanta orange soda near the camera. He wears his Amnifest ring on his hand. Couldn't find any chocolate syrup, but I have some orange soda.
What the fuck? What?
Yeah.
Why do you need chocolate syrup?
Well, bottoms up. And then
No, dude.
Yeah. It's him drinking his own cum.
Fuck. That sucks so much dick. That is horrible.
He's doing like a shot. Like he's at fucking Hooters.
It is fucked up that that is just accessible.
Yeah. No, here's the video of him dancing in the shower.
I would like to watch that.
I'm trying to find it. Shot. I just see screen caps. For whatever reason, they only have the audio of the...
Oh, fuck.
The original ones were on Slut Load. Oh, here we go.
Can be Slug Load?
Slut Load.
A Slut Load. Pornography site?
Yeah.
A pornographic site.
Play video.
I'd like to beat off to pornography.
Let's see if I can get the audio.
I am gay.
Nice.
I only beat off to
gay.
I'm a homosexual. Oh, God. That is fucking... Oh,
hey, honey. May I have this dance?
Oh, no,
that looks like
dude.
The bathroom from Saw.
Yeah, it really does. No. No, his little dick is fucking weird dick. It's little and long. It's I don't get it. Oh no.
It's ballroom dancing in a bathtub,
no,
dude.
Oh,
fuck.
That he looks like Eldis, actually. Like if you told me that's Eldis's body, I wouldn't be shocked. Good lord. Is this did he shave his little pubes? What's going on here? Is he stopping? Is he kissing?
I'm waiting for the part where he loses his balance.
Oh, he's trying to kiss her. Oh, the close-up on his cock is brutal. Yeah.
I don't know. That video is so funny. This is how fucked up the shower is.
Where the balance? Where he didn't fall?
It's when he hits the shower curtain.
Yeah, you make yourself an invisible woman in your imagination. You could do anything with, and then you're like. Ballroom dancing.
This set of pictures showing Chris where, oh yeah, well his nudes that first came out were so funny because he would take flaccid pictures of his penis, which is just like, they look like medical photos.
Yeah.
I mean, like, even if you got a fucking small cock like that, you still like
pump it up,
get it hard, figure out an angle,
the
or
lighting,
you do something
key.
You know, right, women know how to put on makeup, figure out how to take a better dick pic with
I contour dick. My dick
yeah. You know, so it's up close these fucking terrible pictures, but then also just pictures of his ass. He thinks that's what women want to see is a man's ass.
Yeah. Salute to a real one.
Yeah.
You know, whenever a new iPhone comes out, they make a billboard that's like taken with the iPhone X.
Yeah.
A man's ass. Yeah. Like, wow, you can see his pores.
Yeah, taking pictures of his bent dick in fucking portrait mode. This new iPhone X ads make everybody look like an asshole, though, because it's like it's a selfie, but it looks like a headshot, and it's like taken on the iPhone X. It's like, why are you taking pictures like that of yourself?
Yeah.
You know?
Are you trying to make yourself look like you're in a
for the bitches?
You're supposed to take shirtless pictures of your muscles.
Yeah, to send, game
send them
man.
To people you thought you could trust. That's what you do with the iPhone 10. Not these backstabbers. these random backstabbers who I haven't interacted with for more than 5 minutes.
I can't wait till the Skype screen caps start coming
in.
Oh, yeah.
Man. Oh, yeah. It's me ballroom dancing in the shower. Hello, Richard. May I have this dance?
Oh, fuck. We should have said earlier.
Oh, yeah.
The
Baltimore show has been postponed because we don't want to have to, like, try and sell out a huge
It's a
venue.
Bigger venue than we realized.
Yeah. The capacity is, like, 470. So we want to sell out that show. So we're probably going to do... I think you pitched me June 2nd as one of the possible dates. That seems like a good Sunday. So
yeah.
We might do that. That'll give us a month and a half. I got to actually get back to him today to do that.
Yeah.
And then, yeah. We'll pull the trigger on that, but I think we're done here.
Nice,
yeah.
This was a fun one, boys.
Yeah, it was fun. So thanks, Jake, for coming on.
Funny Moms on the 14th of May And I don't think we have anything else to plug, right? Are we doing? No, we don't have. Yeah, so again, the live show is not happening in Baltimore this weekend.
You mind if I plug some shit real quick?
Of course. Yeah.
I'm going on tour with Mishka Shubali. I'm going to.
Is that how he says his name now? He changed it.
Suck Ballsy.
Was it Shubali?
Yeah, wasn't always Shubali.
Mishka Sucks Ballsy.
He made it even more Russian.
I think I've been mispronouncing his name to his face for like years then. I don't give a shit, Mishka. I don't think he listens to this, so...
What? Mishka doesn't listen to Cumtown? I'm heartbroken.
We're going to Morgantown, West Virginia, Detroit, Fort Wayne, Chicago, Madison, Ogawaville, Illinois, where the fuck that is, Kansas City, Hutchinson, Kansas. Then I'm doing a week in Denver. We're doing a bunch of house shows and
hell
shit
yeah.
and bars and
all
stuff
the
like
towns
that.
Where people were sexually abused by their fathers.
Well, that's why we're going. We're going on a tour to, listen to my podcast, Pod Damn America, Mr. Cleo, and I'm on Twitter. All
Pod
shit.
Save America with John Lovett. Check
That's it.
Thanks, okay. Bros.
All right, goodbye, everybody. Oh.
What?
I thought I had something to plug, but...
Do you not? Are you...
Fuck. No.
What do you got? Nothing?
I thought I had something. I guess I don't.
Yeah, I feel like
I gotta book something. Hey, how about this? Yeah. If you book a venue that's anywhere within driving distance from New York and you want to book me for... let's say a two show one nighter somewhere along like 100 capacity anytime in the next month and a half. Yeah, I could do better than 100, but two
you're
shows
trying to work
split
on
it.
Yeah.
Let's
so book
do that.
Me for that and not
book, no book me
book
for that
me?
I'm trying to get back out on the road. It's
book
good for
me.
My blood
so
pressure.
Am I.
I need to get I need to you know I love seeing you guys. You know, I love chatting with you, hanging out after the show, meeting just really meeting the people
the
that make
greets.
All this possible. Because that's me and Amanda Palmer. We love going and meeting all of our beautiful patrons. You know, the people that really just fucking get it.
Oh yeah.
You know, that fucking get what we're doing, dude. That video of like. That Amanda Palmer event where there's that like gay trans southern guy that's like, well, I got into Amanda because my daughter really wanted to see Amanda at Tipitina's when she came through a couple years ago, but she was too young to go. And then my daughter passed away.
So oh, fuck. Jesus fucking Christ.
Yeah, dude, that video was hilarious. I mean, it was tragic, but what an interesting guy. What an interesting type of person to be.
Just agreed.
A weird southern gay trans man with a dead daughter that follows Amanda Palmer around.
Damn, R.I.P.
tribute.
I think that's maybe more about his daughter than Amanda Palmer.
Yeah, yeah. All right, well, it's been a fun one.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Sucking on a dick, I'm gay.
Welcome to Cumtown.
Are we going? Oh,
yes,
nice.
Yes, sir.
Sucking a hard-ass dick. I want some penis.
Sucking on a hard-ass dick. I want some penis.
I had a little lethargy thing going on this week, so it's been like, I'm worried about doing it, but now that I'm getting boosted off crack.
Yeah, dude, now that you're carbo loading,
yeah,
it's about to be fucking on turbo, on double, triple turbo this episode.
Yeah. Get ready for crackers and cigarettes.
Oh, yeah. I smell crackers and cigarettes.
I got fucked in my dick hole.
They used it like a pussy.
There you go. Go ahead, bump it.
I am fucking gay.
Go ahead with your gay ass, Adam.
Busting all the dicks on my cock.
Nice, dude.
That
was awesome.
Very cute, dude.
That was really fucking well done.
Thanks, bro.
Sucking on the middle of the dick, no condom. I just want to fuck a lot of guys because I'm gay. Oh, fuck, dude. That was a real moment in the culture, huh?
Yeah.
What a time to be alive.
Oh, my gosh. What a great record.
What a time to fuck a guy.
What a time. The fuck a guy. It's me and yours. It's me and mine.
That's
it's
you
and
mine.
Yours versus me and mine's. I got a big penis. And I want to get sucked. That was a great record, and it was a horrible time in my life.
Sucking on a penis.
Sucking on a fucking honest dick. I'm gay now. I just want to get fucked in my hands till it hurts.
Yeah, that was a...
That was honestly, because
Drake was basically Kirby, and he would suck all the rappers below him and take their powers until he fucking came up against Future, who was too powerful to steal from.
Yeah.
And if anything, Future actually owned Drake.
He got sucked by Drake.
Future sucked Drake. Drake didn't suck Future.
You're listening to the Real Ass Hip Hop Podcast. With some real ass hip hop heads.
Yeah, we're talking about albums from 6 years ago that we still think about.
6 years ago was basically last year, dude.
That's true.
Once you've acquired age. Mm-hmm.
You know what? The podcast didn't exist when What a Time to Be Alive came out.
Yeah, it's true. We had to mention it.
Back when we were like just getting pussy everywhere.
we were
getting
25.
So much pussy, and then
texting our ex girlfriends, being like, "Just one more time, please."
Just fucking getting pussy in my Camaro.
Yeah, I was in my 57 Chevy.
I was on the varsity. Yeah. I was the varsity.
Me and Adam were hanging out at Pussy Getters,
Pussy Getters.
A diner. We were part of a hot rod crew.
Yeah,
we hang out at diner, and girls go crazy for classic cars.
Dude, you guys were in your fucking LeBaron.
We were like, when women see me drive by in my Ford Model A and finished in Chinese yellow and baby blue fenders.
Yeah, that's right, baby girl. I don't have a seatbelt because they weren't around. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. She's like, "Is that Donald Duck?" When I get out, no pants,
sailor's fucking
top,
little bow tied around the tip of my penis.
Oh yeah, why don't you come undo this bow with your throat, bitch.
Yeah. I tied a yellow ribbon for my brother who went off to fight the Hun.
Yep.
And when he comes back, you can suck the ribbon off. That was life 6 years ago before the podcast. Before I came,
oh my god,
350 pounds eating crackers just to entertain people.
Well, we had to keep waiting for
could do impressions. Does anybody know?
Suck my fucking dick.
Suck my dick, you bitch.
I'm fucking gay now. I was talking to a guy. I want my penis rubbed until it I explode. Come massage this hairy fucking chode. How you doing, folks?
Folks, how you doing? I wanted to ask if any of you have seen the movie Grandma's Boy. I watched it in my hotel room last night. Beautiful film.
Beautiful film. Beautiful audience. Beautiful film.
So you got a great family there. Has anyone ever told you look like Ricky from Malibu's Most Wanted?
I'm only fooling.
We're just having fun here.
I'm
folks.
Sucking off four blacks.
I'm going to tell you, you look like Half-Tooth Larry. Remember that guy? He was one of the fabricators on Monster Garage in one of the episodes. Big fan.
That's a stretch even for us.
Yeah.
We don't know who you're talking about. Shut up. Shut up and suck me off. I paid a child $40 for some top.
Hush money is such a funny concept.
Mm-hmm.
That like you do rape up front and then after the fact
you're like let's settle up.
What's this gonna cost me?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, you got me by the balls here, but be reasonable.
Mm-hmm. That was a very what's his name? Robert Moses. That's how he would fuck children if he could.
Really?
You get the fucking in first.
Oh,
and then
I
figure
see.
Out
I
how
see.
Much
because
it's gonna cost
because
later.
It's the way to do business.
It is.
Mm-hmm. Ask, do, what is it? Do fuck first, ask for permission later?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
Sorry, I was getting a call on my...
You're getting a call from a guy?
From
Jonas.
All right. You don't have to say his name. But.
What I don't have to... Oh, now they're going to find out who Jonas is.
Yeah, they're going to find out.
All of your friends have names like that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Sebastian's also calling.
Yeah, Sebastian. Noah, Jonas.
Christopher.
No, Christopher's not one of them.
No.
It's not Ezra.
I don't have a friend named Sebastian.
Noam.
Film.
Noam with a G.
Yeah. Sham.
Sham.
It's a very soft name.
My penis can't get hard.
Yeah, my friend Ephraim.
Dude, my college roommate 1 year was named Ephraim.
That's
he
great.
Was Ethiopian. He was awesome. He was fat as shit. He got pussy all the time.
Stop, I want to ask you something. Is my name gay?
Tell me seriously, do I have a gay name?
He had a girlfriend that looked like him, but hot, like cartoon characters have girlfriends.
Yeah.
Like, you know how the chipmunks all had his girlfriend? Yeah. He literally had...
This is my girlfriend.
She's hot, Ethiopian. But she was Ethiopian. She had big titties. She was
Mrs.
cute.
Mrs. Donkey Kong.
Ethiopian girls are
no,
hot.
No, that was not her name. His name wasn't Mr. Donkey Kong. Come it was on, Ephraim.
Missy.
No. I was very clear with what his name was. And why would... Okay. I don't remember her name, but I am 100% positive that was not her name.
I have made a mistake. If you excuse me, I forgot to have my afternoon banana.
Okay. That happens to be a good, healthy snack, so I'm going to let that slide.
Because I have diabetes.
Okay. Right? I think he did
my
have...
My blood sugar levels...
He did have some kind of health issue, yeah. If I remember correctly.
It's not a golden banana. It's a regular one.
Mm-hmm. Oh, right, because Donkey Kong gets golden bananas.
That's, of course, her name is Elizabeth. Mrs. Donkey Kong is a fun pet name between the two.
Because
of
we love Nintendo.
Because she loves Nintendo.
And for no other reason.
And we look the same.
No, not that second part that you tried to sneak in. Just Nintendo. Oh, damn. Shouts out to Ephraim. I hope he's doing good, for sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're beautiful.
Yeah, shouts out to the Ethiopians. Shouts out to the Eritreans also mm-hmm. out there.
Shouts out
with your fucking big foreheads.
Shouts out to going on a date.
Those sexy big foreheads.
Yeah, they have big big eyes and big foreheads.
I'm trying to give you a little smooch cute. On that round ass forehead.
Yeah, they do look cute. And they're like tall and slender and beautiful.
You know.
I mean, when I sold cars, there was like I think he was Eritrean. He's either Ethiopian or Eritrean. Mm-hmm. This guy came in. He was bald and he had pointy shoes. He looked like a pirate. He
hell
looked
yeah.
like a Caribbean pirate.
Fuck yeah, dude.
And I was like, this is one of the coolest people I've ever seen. Yeah. And he bought like a navigator with cash.
Oh, so fuck sick. Yeah, dude. Wow. Maybe he was a pirate.
Mm-hmm.
Came off the tanker. Mm. I watched a movie about a pirate called
Captain Blood.
Now.
What?
I watched a movie called Captain Blood. It's starring my boy Errol Hurt.
Errol Flynn?
Errol Flynn.
Yeah, Errol Hurt.
Who's Errol Hurt?
I don't know.
Me.
Errol.
My name's
man, Errol Hurt.
Who's
my
Errol? From now on, my name is Errol Hurt.
And that's not a bad name.
My middle name is Discona.
Errol Discona Hurt. That's good, man.
Star my boy.
Who's a juicy orange?
That looks good.
Mm-hmm.
You want a slice?
I'm good, brother.
Yeah,
thank
I get
you.
Can I get a little piece?
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, brother.
Suck my dick and balls.
You know what's cool about oranges is that the season for them is winter.
That is
you
cool.
Think fruits, and you don't think
you think
winter.
Fruits. You think
what
Adam
the fuck
Freeman.
Is this bullshit? People are like, oh, fruits have seeds. I've never gone to a grocery store and not.
Hold
been
on.
Able to get.
It's not a bullshit thing.
It's not a bullshit.
That's one of the most basic
Mexico
things in from the world.
No, because I go to a grocery store and I'm like, I need apples.
Yeah,
they're
shittier certain times of the year. Apples are better in the fall.
Yeah, they got to get them flown in.
Yeah, you get some bullshit lab grown apple or some dog shit.
Mm, that is a good orange.
Mm-hmm.
Oranges are better in the winter. Stone fruits are better in the summer.
I know how to pick them. Here, go
apples
ahead.
Are in the fall.
Thanks, brother.
Have the rest.
What is it with oranges and they have like their brother growing out of them at the end?
So true.
I don't like
that. Son, I don't know if it's a brother. That's not how brothers work.
Well, it's, what if it's Siamese?
It could be like a fucked up pygmy brother.
Yeah. Adam's like getting fucked in the ass by his dad and he's like, I'm going to have a brother. My dad said I'm going to have a brother.
That's incredibly rude. That's incredibly rude.
Everyone in school's going to be jealous. My dad's making a brother.
Listen, I get to have my own brother.
I'm going to have my own brother.
Listen, it's
just
funny,
like mommy
that,
made
that
me. I'm going to make a brother.
I'm my own mommy now. I'm the mommy. That's mean but very funny.
Why is it mean?
Suck me on the dick. Because you're accusing his father of fucking him in the ass.
Wow.
Yeah, but I guess in the joke I was kind of the puller of strings.
No,
there.
No, you're getting molested straight up. No. Don't even try and flip this in the joke.
The brother is the hush bunny. Yeah.
You're being told you're having a brother, yeah. But you're getting molested.
Do you think
there
was anyone that was like molested for Pokemon cards?
Definitely, without question, like thousands of kids. That's probably one of the most common ways people were molested. School,
I guess you got a Charizard.
Whoa, how'd you do it?
Shut up.
Don't even.
I don't remember.
I found it.
Dude, without question.
Yeah, just now you're like fucking, you're 28 years old. You're just like trying to take the DSA seriously. To press down the memory of sucking dick for a shiny Clefairy.
I was thinking maybe our subcommittee, as a fun thing, yeah, our mascot could be Snorlax. No! Yeah. No!
I'm sorry. We can do whatever you want.
That's offensive. Some of us may have been raped for that.
Fuck.
Not me, but some
balls.
People could have.
Dude, absolutely. A lot of people got molested for Pokemon cards, without question.
Oh, that would have been a good
one. I got fleeced by one of my neighbors. He told me the Japanese Pokemon cards are worth more.
Yeah, that's what I thought too.
And I got and he took all my good cards for a bunch of bullshit.
Shit, then, you couldn't even read.
Shit, I couldn't even read, dude. I got and you know what, dude? What was really fucked up was he worked. His dad was my dad was his dad's boss, so I let this fucking man. You know
wow,
what I'm saying?
That was the workers.
The workers over there, dude. Yeah. How dare these motherfuckers?
Dude, you walk in.
Today's Tom
like,
Sawyer, dude.
Yep.
Acting like the rich kid in, the rich kid in Greek Town.
The rich kid in Greek Town who somehow had a shittier house. I think my dad was just paying that guy. My dad just wanted to pretend he was rich, so he had an employee
he
couldn't
employee,
afford.
Yeah.
Like, their house was so much nicer than ours. All his shit was better. I mean, he was an only child, but I had, you know, two brothers, cousin.
You got to ski race that guy down the mountain, dude.
Well, that kid was also being molested. So
that's true. Yeah, yeah.
He'd make the house nice to hush him up.
That'd be funny if he got molested.
How about shush money? And it's just like you can tell a couple of people.
Mm.
Just keep it quiet.
Shh, shh, shh. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hush is total silence.
Yeah.
But
don't
shush.
Blabbering around
is
town.
Use your discretion.
Yeah. Well, keep your voice down.
Yeah,
only,
your voice down
yeah, only whisper it to the fellas.
That Pokemon card thing is very funny to me. Just bad deals.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Damn, that guy really got me. And I didn't feel good about it either. He you know what he did to me? He treated me like Al Pacino. He was Al Pacino in
The Untouchables.
Glengarry Glen Ross.
Oh.
No, he wasn't in The Untouchables.
Yeah, I know. I'm thinking of Andy Garcia.
That is true. Didn't he play... What was Andy Garcia? He was Sonny's love child in Godfather 3.
He was his brother that grew out of his asshole.
That's right. Just like the orange. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Or was he... No.
Italians are like that, too.
Was he in Carlito's Way? No, right?
Andy Garcia? He was in Godfather 3.
That's what I just
I hope Donald Trump becomes president again in 2024. How funny would that
I would love it.
If you think people
so
were
much.
Upset last time...
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
And he's going to... It's like, what does he have to lose?
Mm-hmm.
He can't run for re-election.
They're going to keep talking about, like, this is just how, like, Hitler went to jail and he came back. But it'd be funny if this cycle continues and Donald Trump lives to be like 130, and then he'll come back, be an even shittier president,
mm-hmm.
burn down the White House.
Yep.
You know, like fucking like I'm opening an Orange Julius. Like it should get worse and worse every time.
Yeah.
And then there's just some dickhead, you know, Democrat, and then Donald Trump escapes from prison and becomes
president again.
Yeah.
We're like, all right, if he loses, he goes to jail. Yeah. But if he wins, he gets to be president.
Yeah, he just keeps his...
And they're like, oh, Kamala's not losing. You better believe. There's no way.
He's escaping from Arkham, dude. He's like the Joker.
Fuck yeah. That'd be awesome.
It's just like comic books.
You see that picture of him? He's not looking too good.
Trumpy?
Yeah.
He's looked like shit for years. Who cares?
Yeah, I tell you, I didn't watch any of the...
I saw a couple clips. He's got the magic.
I didn't see any of the clips, but just the stills of him at CPAC with his like classic huge ass move.
His dumper
just,
is so
yeah,
big.
Just I mean, he has a duck's body.
His fucking skeleton I would love to see.
Continue.
I would love to take a look at an x-ray.
I would love to see him without his clothes on.
Absolutely. How much shit do you think he has in his
We're
going to
sit out on the pond, and there's going to be little pieces of bread, and we're going to nibble on the bread, and it's going to be beautiful.
Dude, I bet you if that guy got a colonic, he would lose like 50 pounds. He's probably got a lot of shit in it. Although, I respect the Diet Coke.
I don't shit, folks.
I don't need
shit. I haven't
shit
in years. Doctors say it's bad for me. I haven't had taken a dump in 4 years.
How he stands is fucking awesome.
Yeah, his stance is
amazing.
I guess
that's true, because
he's like
on
leaning forward a little bit.
Always. Yeah, he's on Twitter all the time, but half his guys aren't ever on the internet. So he goes to CPAC, he probably crushed.
Well, he's offline, so I was hoping that he'd really save his best zingers for CPAC, but it seems like the clips I saw were mostly scripted speech.
Honestly, it was like watching Chappelle come back.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah. Not quite as good as his prime,
folks,
but still some beautiful moments.
Yeah, folks, I went to Africa. My father said, if shit ever gets bad, you got to go to Africa. You got to get your mind right. The white man's trying to take my money away
honestly,
from me.
He should just tease running and then hire like Shane Gillis and Tim secretly. And just start do like treat everything like stand up.
That would be awesome.
You know,
he's the best comedian in the world.
Yeah,
yeah. Whatever he can do to hurt the country, I'm on board with.
Suck my fucking dick. It is. Yeah. Damn. I bet. What do you think his days are like, man?
Now,
just chilling, playing golf.
He lives at a country club, bro. He's probably bummed about Tiger.
That's true. That was his guy.
That was his boy.
He's probably pissed about Tiger.
We used to fuck dogs together, yeah. Folks.
I am like legitimately relieved Cuomo's getting the axe.
Yeah.
Because a little part of me was worried.
Well, now you have to say thank you to the gals over at the Me Too movement.
Yeah, I'll say thank you. Which have... Long and slow. You know what I'm talking about.
Nice. You'll write a note. You'll write a nice thank you letter. Long and slow, huh?
Yeah, I'm really glad he's getting his comeuppance, dude.
But Will, what you think they're going to make him resign?
Like the dumb shit.
He's hiring defense attorneys. Like,
it's always the most pathetic.
Taking over.
The most pathetic Me Too. Like Al Franken got canceled for like pretending to touch a woman's tits.
Over
like a 12-year-old
flak jacket.
Over a flak jacket.
And Cuomo's like just horrifically bad at hitting on
people.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
You know, the youngest I would go is how old are you again? 25. 24 is the youngest I would go. Do you have a boyfriend? Is he an effeminate dinosaur? Have you ever considered having sex with an effeminate dinosaur? Perhaps Barney, if the suit was made out of an old trash bag filled with vomit.
I am going to open my penis. Something like that, you know? Mm-hmm.
This is what they do to
all. It is
all
so
great.
Funny. He straight up just killed a bunch of old people.
Yeah, but he's getting it for being bad and trying to get pussy. Yeah. It's so funny. He killed a million old people and
he's
covered
like,
up the numbers. But he
rules. But he pulls one Aziz Ansari and he's got to go.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he doesn't. Then I gave him the clove.